The organizational meeting of the Committee on Social Justice, Welfare, and Rural Development is now called to order. Okay. Pursuant to Article 10, Section 27 of the Rules of the Senate, the Committee on Social Justice, Welfare, and Rural Development shall be composed of 7 members. For the information of everyone, the members of the committee, for the majority, Senator Maria Lourdes Nancy Binay, Senator Juan Miguel Subiri, Senator Joseph Victor Ejercito, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, Senator Laila De Lima. For the minority, Senator Antonio Trillanes IV. Okay. At this point, we're waiting for the presence of our senators. But in the meantime, I would like to acknowledge our guest list for this morning. Nandito po si Yusek Florita R. Villar, Policy and Plans Group. Okay, where is she? Okay. Yusek Mateo Montaño, General Administration and Support Services. Okay. Yusek Vilma Cabrera, Operation and Program Group. Okay. ASEC Maria Lourdes Toralde Harabe, OPG Promotive Program. Okay. ASEC Hope Vargas Hervilla, Protective Programs. Okay. Director Leonardo C. Reynoso, okay. Pantawid Pamilya Pilipino Program. Hi, thank you. Director Edmond Monteverde, OIC Sustainable Livelihood Program. Director Paz Sarino, Protective Services Bureau. Okay. Director Marites Maristela, Standard Bureau. Okay. I wish to acknowledge the presence of Senator Laila De Lima, one of our members of the Committee on Social Justice, Welfare, and Rural Development. I'd like to inform this body that today is the first meeting of your Committee on Social Justice, Welfare, and Rural Development. But before this committee can start its business, we needed first to organize and approve the rules that would govern the conduct of the committee. I'd like to announce that the committee is adopting and subscribing to the pertinent provision of the rules of the Senate and the rules governing inquiries in aid of legislation, which was adopted by the Senate and published on February 18, 2013, in various newspapers of general circulation. This rule shall be observed during the conduct of the meetings, hearings, and investigation of the committee. Upon motion of, can you make the motion to approve?
Okay. Yes, Madam Chair, I move to approve the rules governing the proceedings of this committee.
Upon the motion of Senator De Lima and there being no objection, I move that the same be adopted and declare that this committee is now duly organized. Okay. In my review of the programs of the DBSWD, my attention focused on the Pantawid Pamilya Pilipino Program, a social protection program that focuses on the human development by providing cash grant to indigent household. The program starts from the conception of the child by giving maternal care to the mother when the baby is born, and providing health care through provision of vitamins by giving the child a better access to education and access to economic opportunities. The other program is the disaster response that is very important to a country that, not only stricken by poverty, but by disaster as well. The department has a lot of programs, and all of their programs are aimed towards giving the citizenry a better life. And I want to know what are this program, and if this program have solved the poverty problem of the Philippines. It is unfortunate that after spending billions of pesos and doing this for 10 years, our poverty level has not moved at 27%. It was 27% in 2010. It's still 27% in 2016. That's why I, being the oversight committee of your department, I would like to exercise my oversight functions. And I want to know if you have studied your model, because I'm thinking that there must be something wrong with the model. that after 6 years of spending so much money, you did not make a dent on the poverty of the Philippines. So I would give you a chance to present your presentation to me so I can understand your program better. But I would want to ask you if there's any kind of review that you are doing so that you can review your program and maybe find out what's wrong with the program, why it is not solving the poverty problem of our country. Of course, I would ask first my fellow senator, Senator De Lima, if you want to make some comments on this.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Well, I just want to, of course, welcome the team from the DSWD, and I would certainly want to listen to your briefing, although in about 5 to 10 minutes, I need to excuse myself first, Madam Chair, but I will be coming back. I just have an appointment here in the Senate, so it would be a maximum of 30 minutes. I can always come back and then listen to your presentation, and then, of course, we would have a chance to also ask some questions. Just like the Madam Chair, we want to know exactly the success, the level of success or lack of it of the anti-poverty programs of the DSWD. Now, if you confirm the poverty level cited by the Madam Chair, then we would want to know also, given all the programs, particularly the 4 P's that the Pinoy administration had intently implemented, we would want to know the reasons why, as Madam Chair has said, that it has not taken a dent. Or maybe one way of looking at it also, if 4 P's is not there, would the poverty situation in the country would have gotten worse? That is another way of looking at it. And I would want to know whether the current administration, especially the administration of the DSWD, is minded to push for either a modification or an abrogation of that program. We want to hear from you. We want to get your honest answers to those questions for our guidance, especially as an oversight committee. Thank you.
For the information of Senator De Lima, we will be staying here at until 12, from 9 to 12, because I have to adjourn at 12 because we have a meeting of the Senate Electoral Tribunal at 12:30. So you can come back anytime before 12. We'll be here. Okay?
Yes, Madam Chair. May I be excused, and I'll be coming back after 30 minutes or so.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator De Lima. Okay. So we now proceed to the briefing on the status of the programs being conducted by your department so that the Senate and Congress, for that matter, can review and improve the programs through legislation in order to best serve and assist our people. But before we start with the briefing to be provided by the DSWD, okay, I want to give priority to the following in the presentation: the Pantawid Pamilyang Pilipino Program, Disaster Prone Program, Social Pension for Indigent Senior Citizen, PAMANA, and Assistance to Individual in Crisis Situation. Yung PAMANA ba yun yung livelihood? No, it's in the, nasaan yung livelihood? PAMANA is in the conflict areas. Nasaan yung livelihood dito? Nasaan yun? Oh, isama yun, but hindi sinama yun. Can you please include that? Can I have a ball pen? But hindi mo sinama yun? Oh, but hindi mo sinama dito? Can we now start with the presentation?
Okay.
Good morning, Honorable Chair, Senator Sinchay Villar, Chair of the Committee on Social Justice, Welfare, and Development. The DSWD is thankful for giving us the opportunity to present to you and brief you on the DSWD programs and services. There will be two presentations, Madam Chair. The first one will be focused on the protective programs, which include the disaster risk reduction management programs of the department and other initiatives, including the assistance to individuals in crisis situation, as you mentioned a while ago. The second to be done by our Undersecretary Vilma Cabrera. The next presentation will be on the promotive programs, which include the Pantawid, the Sustainable Livelihood Program, and the NCDDP, or the Kalahi.
If you look at your budget, the biggest bulk of the budget is in the Pantawid, di ba? So we start with Pantawid. Start, okay. When you make presentations, you start with the biggest budget because it's the order of importance. We should review the first, the biggest budget, then we go to the budget that are becoming smaller. So, ganyan talaga, kasi we will not have enough time. I want to see the programs which has the biggest budget.
Okay, thank you, Your Honor.
We start with that kind of presentation. Kung sino yung pinakamalaki budget mauna? Para kung matapos, maliit na lang yung naiwan sa atin. Huh?
Okay, thank you, Your Honor. So we'll start
and
with
from
the...
The biggest budget is Pantawid, 78 billion. Social pension to indigent senior citizens, 18 billion. And then assistance to this... The third one is Pamana, 808 million, and the fourth one is a combination of 181, 1 million, 182, 290 million, or about 300 million assistance to disadvantaged municipalities. Ang ballpen ba dito? Okay. So we go by order of budget, ha? The biggest budget going to the smallest budget. So if you look at the budget, we go first four piece, second to the social pension for indigent senior citizen, the third is the PAMANA, the fourth is the assistance to all disadvantaged municipalities, around 400 million. And then, ano yung livelihood? Magkano budget noon? Huh? Yung livelihood 9.6 billion
po,
billion?
Your Honor.
Oh, eh, malaki pala yun eh. Oh, ano yung livelihood? Ano nun? 10 billion? Okay. So number one is four piece, number two is social pension, number three is livelihood, number four is PAMANA, number five is assistance to disadvantaged municipalities. Between all of these, if you add them up, it's 78, 90, 100, and then 101 million. And your total budget is 129, and ang PS nyo ba? Ano, magkano PS nila? And overhead. Kasi huwag mo pagsama-samahin dito sa MOOE na to, hindi man totoo itong MOOE na to. Magkano ang PS nyo? And then your admin, yung overhead nyo. Ang PS nyo?
Our PS is 5.3 billion, that's 4.16% of total.
Okay, ilang
budget.
Percent?
4.16% of our budget.
And then your overhead... Wag yung MOOE, hindi yan overhead. Napakalaki niya. Nandiyan yung Pantawid niyo eh. Oh. Magkano ang overhead niyo? Yung admin niyo?
Admin for Pantawid Pamilya.
No, everything, the department.
Our breakdown here is only by expense.
No,
class.
You break it down to me. I want to know your admin. You tell me your overhead. Kasi alam mo, ang negosyo... or any organization, dalawa lang yan, overhead and program. I want to know how much you're spending for your overhead and PS, and I want to know how much you're spending for program.
Our general administration and support services expenses, 572 million, that's 0.44% of our budget.
Yun lang ang overhead nyo?
Well, we have support to operations, that's 545 million, that's 0.42% of our total budget.
Another 500 million?
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Then what else?
That's all, ma'am.
So your overhead is 1 billion?
Yes,
so you're
ma'am.
Only spending 6 billion?
Yeah.
Something like that,
yes,
to, for overhead, and the rest are all programs.
Yes, ma'am.
So all programs, so if you're spending, let's say, 6 billion out of the total budget of what? 129, diba? Minus 7. Ipagalayin na natin 7. You have to account for 122 na program. Itong sinusuma natin program nyo, 101 lang to. Nasa na iba?
Ma'am, could I clarify,
capital
ma'am?
Capital outlay.
Our overhead is about...
Let's account your budget.
Yes, 1.1 billion, our overhead. And
5.3 on PS. So that's 6.3.
That's right, ma'am. You're right, ma'am.
Ngayon, ang inyong budget is 129. Tapos ang accounted for ng DSWD program, dito sa listahan nyo, 101, di ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Nasa na iba?
So our,
you have a 129 budget. Lagay na natin 130. Lagay na natin 7 billion ng overhead. You have to account for 123.
Yes.
Ang in-account ng program nyo is 101, di ba?
Yes.
Nasa ng 22?
Our total budget for operations, including that includes also some of our PS, is 116 billion. That includes...
Ba't nakalagay dito, total budget nyo is 129?
Mayroon pa po kaming locally funded projects and we have foreign assisted projects.
Ano yon? Magkano yon?
Our operations...
Di ba ito ang locally funded project assistance to disadvantaged municipalities? Hindi ito yon?
Kasama po yan. Pati social pension kasama rin po yan.
Hindi nga. Ibig sabihin, I'm asking you, just divide your budget na... PS, admin, overhead, and then programs. Di ina-add na natin ngayon. May nawawalan 22 billion. Nasaan yun?
We could, ma'am, our present presentation today is
I just want to have a general idea na may 129 billion budget kayo. Paano nyo dinivide in very broad terms? Kaya tinatanong kita, how did you spend the 129 billion? So far, you have accounted to me yung 7 billion yun na overhead, PS, and admin. So may natitirang 123, di ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Ngayon, in-account mo sa akin yung program mo costing you 101 billion, okay?
Yes,
so
ma'am.
May nawawalang 22. So tinatanong ko sa iyo, nasan yung 22?
Could I reconfigure that, ma'am, and present to you after this, ma'am?
Kasi okay, ito yung you, summary.
We'll recompute because our presentation
na natin
is different.
Uli. Kasi we should start para clear ang mind ko, ganito yung division ng budget, and then i-explain nyo sa akin yung program budget because that's where I'm interested. But
okay.
I want you to account your budget, how you divided it.
Can you give us a little time for us to recompute, ma'am?
Ngayon.
Okay. Compute calculator. See this. Paki-compute muna. Kasi i-recall out natin yung 5.3 na PS.
Thank you. Tawid, because that is the biggest budget, 78 billion. Do you have a list of your beneficiaries sa Pantawid? Ilan beneficiary yan? Bigyan niyo ako ng program. I want a computer na nandun nakalista lahat ang beneficiary niyo sa Pantawid. At gusto kong i-access yon. At kung halimbawa, pupunta ako sa isang probinsya, makikita ko kung ilan ang Pantawid doon. Bigyan niyo ako na isang computer sa office ko. I want to see yung program niyo ng beneficiary niyo ng Pantawid. Kasi for 6 years, walang nakakakita yung listahan na yon. Nasaan ba yung listahan na yon? I want that list. I want them all accounted for. Okay? You show me your beneficiary of your Pantawid and how much you are giving them, ano yung gastos nyo. Gusto ko yun nasa computer ko. Bigyan nyo ako na isang computer na laman nyo. Next time, ha? I would ask my ComSec to submit to me. Give me one computer in my office. I want a list of those Pantawid program beneficiary. Let's account for yung 78 billion na yun kung kanino ibibigay, ha? Okay.
Okay. Good morning, Madam Chair. All right. Okay, about the Pantawid beneficiaries.
Mm-hmm.
Our current list at the moment, we are serving 4.397 million. Oh, that's households. Households. So that's 4,397,171 to be exact.
Did by town, by province, and by region, and total.
Yes.
So you give me that list.
Yes, can we move to the slide?
And I want the names. I want the names.
Yes. We will be giving the names to you, and I am instructing Director Leo Reynoso.
You will give me a computer with the names.
Yes.
Oh, I want a computer with the names. So people, if they ask me, I can access if they are beneficiary of Pantawid or not. The computer file of the names, okay?
Yes, we will be providing you with that list, ma'am. But for the meantime, what we can show to you is the breakdown per municipality. Can we move to the slide where we have the data? Move to the next slide, please. Yes. So currently, the number of active household beneficiaries by region as of August 31st, 2016, you can see there that number one would be ARMM with 417,703 households. Next is region five with 375,787, followed by region 9. Okay, region 9 that has 322,579, and then 4A, 317,608, and then what's next? Region 3 with 290,076 households. And then the National Capital Region with 232,258. Of course, Madam Chair, we can actually give you a drill down data per city, per municipality.
Can we acknowledge Senator Binay? Do you want to make any comment?
No.
Okay, so we proceed. You give me the names of your CCT beneficiary, National Capital Region, Las Piñas City. I want to see that. Okay, can you give it to me? Okay. I-hard copy mo, ha? Bigay mo sa chief of staff ko.
Yes. So we will be coordinating with your chief of staff. That's attorney.
Beneficiary nyo sa Las Piñas City?
Can you give us a bit of time? It's actually in the...
Okay, give me.
Okay.
Give me.
So in the meantime...
Give me a rough idea of how many in Las Piñas City. Just a rough idea. That's not the exact one.
Could it be anywhere between...
How many families?
Yes. It could be anywhere between 50 and 60,000.
Las Piñas?
Yes. We are Yes.
How can that be? We have only 100,000 household, Iha. We are, a population is 520,000, divided by 5, that's 100,000 household. And our poverty figure is 1.8%, so it cannot be 50,000. 2% of 100,000 is 2,000. You give me the list, the hard copy of that. So I just want to see who are they. Okay.
Plus 16,000.
Kayo, ilang pati?
Oh, sorry.
That's yun nga din huhingin ko, eh, Madam Chair. Can I also request for the list of
Makati? Sorry, Makati.
Okay, I stand corrected. So the figure is more than 3,000 households for Las Piñas. So that is 3,026 for the regular CCT and 15 households for the modified CCT.
Alam mo, ang poverty figure lang namin is 1.8. And we have only 100,000 families. So 1.8 of 100,000 is 2,000. How come you have 3,000 beneficiaries? I want to see the list.
Okay, ma'am, we will be, we will drill down to that data and provide you.
Ang list nyo, nare-revise nyo yan kung sino na yung hindi naman deserving na through time. Nagre-revise kayo. Who is revising?
Senator, within the SWD, we have a national household targeting system for poverty reduction. Mm-hmm. And we do an enumeration every 4 years. We just concluded the 2015. That's the second round of our nationwide
system. So you're changing the numbers?
Based on the result.
Oh, ano ngayon ang naging number? 4 million pa rin.
Titingnan ko po ulit.
Oh, yeah. Can you give me an idea how it started in 2010 and now how it is in 2015? So we'll have an idea.
Madam Chair, pwede mo ba kami kumuha ng kopya ng national household targeting?
Yes. I'm asking them, just like the one I asked from PhilHealth, their beneficiary in a computer, I'm asking them to give us a computer where they have the 4,397,000 by region, by province, by municipality or city. And I think Senator Nancy Binay would want to know also. So can you give us both a computer?
Madam Chair, I think yung national household targeting is your internal survey.
Yes, yes. But they have a list.
Baka we can get a copy of the result nung 2015.
For the nationwide or for your...
For the nationwide.
Okay. As an oversight committee, because for the rest, we're still entering into a memo with them.
Pwede namang mali-mali yun, but we want to know the result. So we will have an idea. You don't have to be defensive. If there's something wrong, at least what we want is a general idea of what's happening. Ako nga, kung ako, i-round up ko to sa nearest billion. Kasi I want to memorize it by heart. Na pag tinanong ako, na memorize ko to. O ilan yung beneficiary, magkano nagasta doon, what happened in 2010 and what happened in 2015. Kasi amazed na amazed lang ako that after spending so much on the CCT program, ganun pa rin ang kahirapan sa Pilipinas. Doon ako na-amazed. And in fact, I go abroad to find other models of CCT kasi baka there's something wrong with our model. Did you ever think of a study that we should review our model? Kasi kung mali yung model natin, why will continue it for the next 6 years and fail? Review ba kayo? Na enter ba sa mind nyo na maybe the model is wrong?
Okay. Madam Chair, may I just... share with you that I am part of the team of Secretary Judy Tagiwalo. So as we entered, it is of interest to us that while there had been strides according to the reports they submitted to us in terms of education and health outcomes, it remains to be seen whether the pantawid, no, as a social protection strategy has indeed contributed to the reduction of poverty. So we're actually interested, no, to review.
I was asked by the former secretary of DAR to go to Brazil because he wanted me to see the Brazil model, because the Brazil model is tied up with agriculture. They ask the farmers to produce crops. The government buys crop. They use the money to buy crops and make it to feed it to their children. Which is the biggest CCT program in the world, Brazil. I don't know about the Mexican model, but in Thailand, I went there, and it's also tied up with agriculture. The government of Thailand requires that 6 million children drink milk every day, 200 ml of milk every day, and they buy the milk from the local dairy industry. So nag-boom yung dairy industry nila, and at the same time, lahat ng bata, 6 million children of them are drinking milk every day, 200 ml, paid by the government. So that is their program. I was thinking, how come our program is never tied up with agriculture when the poorest people in the Philippines are in agriculture? Yes. 60% of all our coconut farmers are earning 50 pesos a day or 1,500 a month. And they are the poorest. And then 60% of the 3.5 million coconut farmers. Now, the 40% of our farmers and fisher folks are living below the poverty line. And they are minus, there are 11.8 million farmers in the Philippines. You minus the coconut farmers of 3.5, that's 8 million. Oh. 8 million farmers in the Philippines. So if you want to reduce poverty in the Philippines, I believe you should tie it up with agriculture, because if you can reduce the poor in agriculture, then you reduce poverty. But our CCT program has never been tied up with agriculture. It's always tied up with health and education. At marami kaming nadidinig, ibinibigay nyo ba yung CCT dun sa inyong, ano tawag doon? Yung inyong ATM, di ba? Ang nadidinig namin, yung mga beneficiary nyo, sinasanla yung ATM at kumikita lang sa inyo yung mga nagpa-5-6 na pinagsasanlaan ng ATM, at yung sinasanla nila ang buong ATM nila for the year, at nagtotongits na lang sila. Ganun ang chismis dyan sa CCT program nyo. Kaya I was thinking na maybe we're not against CCT. We're really supportive that you spend $78 billion for CCT. But maybe we should review the model so that it will reduce poverty. Yung sinasabi nyong better health, I think better health should be taken care of by PhilHealth. They have $42 billion budget a year. Baka hindi naman kayo ang dapat mag-alaga ng better health for the people. It should be PhilHealth and DOH. And then you take care maybe of education and helping these people become better off and not living below the poverty line. But by giving them livelihood, para may kita sila. Education, baka hindi dapat yung education, kailangan yung education ng farmers ang gawin nyo para yung farmer matutong mag-farming para sila mas lumaki ang kita. Maybe there's something wrong with the model. Why are you insisting on health? Di ba DOH yun? At pinasa natin ang Sintax, and they have a collection of $150 billion a year para magbigay ng universal health care for the people. So it's the problem of DOH to provide health care, and your problem is to reduce poverty, not improve the health care of the people.
Okay, thank you, Madam Chair, for...
Why do you tie up with health? Eh, problema ng ano yun? Ng DOH yun. Ang dami-dami nilang pera. 150 billion ang collection ng Sintax, and that's for universal health care. So... ang binibigay sa PhilHealth is $42 billion, tapos the rest being given to the Department of Health. para to improve the government hospitals. Oh, bakit nyo kinukuha yung healthcare? Oh, hindi nyo problema yon. Ang problema nyo, bawasan ng kahirapan. You will not be judged by improving the healthcare of the people. DOH will be judged for that and PhilHealth. You will be judged on how you reduce poverty because that is your aim, reduction of poverty in the Philippines.
Thank you, Madam Chair, for giving us that observation. And the CCT in Brazil is the Bolsa Familia. Okay, CCT is seen there as a complement along with other social protection programs. And same thing with Mexico, Oportunidades, it's the same thing. In the Philippines, however, well, it's basically
they buy the produce of the farmers. They don't give just the money to the people.
Yes. So there are other side-by-side social protection programs that actually complement their CCT. So now, as part of the new team that came in, of course, our idea is, number one, poverty reduction is not just the sole responsibility of the DSWD. In fact, it is the whole government and all other agencies should be helping one another. So we're looking at a convergent strategy towards that direction. And then number two, in terms of really drilling down, understanding poverty, and looking for a model that would best suit that, I think we will have to first assess where we are right now, look at our possible strengths, understand the gaps, and maybe bring in new ideas that could actually spell some difference. However, at this point, may I just share with the chair and the Senator Binay that we are covenanted. We have a covenant with the World Bank and the ADB also, no? That right now, what the model is really just working around health and education. So we want to understand that also. But in the meantime,
utang yan?
Yes, it is.
Oh, ibig sabihin, nangungutang ka, ididikta nila kung saan natin dadalhin. Oh, di ba tayo mangutang para hindi nila ididikta kung saan natin dadalhin? Ibig sabihin, kahit natingin natin, mali yan dahil pinautang nila tayo, susundin natin sila. Ha? I don't think it's your job to do health. It's the job of Department of Health. You should do livelihood. You should increase the income of the people who are poor. You are not mandated to do health. Bakit tayo susunod sa World Bank? Gaano katagal pa yung World Bank na yan?
The DSWD started with the CCT in 2009. So that's about seven, eight years. Well, hanggang 2019 po, Madam Chair. Yes.
10 years. So if it's failing after 6 years, we still continue up to the 10th year. Ganun ba?
I think we should be doing an earnest review on that, Madam Chair.
Ibig mo sabihin, hindi nyo makuha sa World Bank na mali yung model?
We will do that, but it has to be based on... of course, currently, the World Bank, together with the SWD, has done two waves already of researches evaluating the outcomes, and there's a third wave. But at this point, we also want to invite independent researchers to help us understand this better. And in so doing, we may be able to have a space to actually interrogate, critique the model that we have. And on the basis of that, we can probably say to World Bank, that, these are the items we found out.
No, I can understand education, but health I cannot understand because we have a DOH to take care of that. I can understand pa yung education, but the health aspect I cannot understand.
I think, Madam Chair, naging thrust to atin ng World Health was to encourage pregnant women to undergo prenatal.
The DOH can do that. Why will the SWD do that?
I think which was also part of the Brazil model na pag pregnant, part ng CCT nila was pag pregnant ka, para magkaroon ka ng prenatal care. Isasama ka sa CCT because I think malaking problema din ho ata yung pag nagbubuntis, wala hong prenatal care, pupunta na lang.
It's a health problem. And ang laki-laki, kasi malaki din ang budget nyo ang health. Oh, that they should solve that. Hindi tayo. Kayo, kasi in the end, kaya kayo napipintasan, ang inyong ano is poverty reduction. And you have not moved poverty for the last 6 years.
The last time I looked into the vision and mission of DSWD, DSWD is basically contributing to social protection. So,
this one is poverty reduction to CCT. Kasi ang kaya yan nabibigyan ng budget na ganyan kasi poverty reduction yan. Eh, hindi nag-move ang poverty. Anong klaseng program yan? Eh, ang laki-laki niyan. It's the same budget as the Department of Agriculture. Boom budget, 78 billion. Oh. Ano ba napapakinabang sa inyo ng World Bank? Kaya iyan ang ifinance nila. And bakit ba tayo kailangang mangutang para dyan?
I think, Madam Chair,
I just want to understand the ano.
May authority ho ba? I think may authority naman yung DSWD to expand yung scope of beneficiaries.
Or to change the model.
Or to change the scope of beneficiaries. May leeway ho ba tayong ganon dito sa CCT? Or do we always have to ask World Bank na babaguhin namin yung programa, dadagdagan namin, babawasan namin?
Magkano utang nyo, inuutang nyo sa World Bank yearly for this?
Yan.
Yes, for the next 5 years. Yes. You're on. Uh-oh.
Yes, Your Honor, I would like to volunteer that the portion that is being financed by World Bank is only about 6% of the total households only.
Ganyan ang model mo dahil pinifinance na World Bank. Eh, maliit lang pala pinifinance na World Bank. Eh, di tanggalin niyo World Bank at tayo na lang. And then, baguhin natin ang model kung yun ang makaka-reduce ng poverty sa Pilipinas. Oh, ano ba yan? Colonial mentality ba yan? Nasunod tayo ng sunod sa World Bank? Oh. Eh, hindi naman pala sila nagbibigay ng pera sa atin. Ako, okay na sa akin 60 billion basta we have the independence to decide what is best for us. Kesa 80 billion na dinidikta nila sa atin. Eh, si Tagiwalo pa naman, eh, leftist. Eh, bakit siya sumusunod sa World Bank?
May I just share something on that, ma'am? Yes. Of course, I come from that side also. Okay, so we belong to the same, yes. Yes. That's why, yes.
Ating mga 1/4 of our population na poor, na sinasabi nyo na itataas nyo kahirapan, hindi nyo naman na itataas. Oh. Tapos, nakikita ko on the ground. Oh. Ilan ang tatanungin kita, iti beneficiary mo dun sa ano, Baseco. Sabi mo nga sa akin, oh, nasan yung NCR nyo? Yung NCR director nyo, nasaan? Ilan ang CCT beneficiary do sa Baseco? Sabihin niyo sa akin, I've never seen so much poverty in my life in Baseco. Sabi nila 8,000 daw. Gusto ko malaman ko ilan.
For NCR, that's 232,000.
Oh,
for Baseco it's 7,000.
Oh, see, 7,000 ang beneficiary niyo. Ilan ang tao doon? Ilan ang pamilya doon? Sapun libo? Hindi Tondo yon. District 5 of Manila. Kay Bagat Singh.
Ang covered po, ma'am, ay for the whole of Tondo, it's 10,000.
It's not Tondo. It's District 5 of Manila, Baseco. Nasaan ba yung NCR director? Bakit wala siya? Puro kami NCR dito. We're interested in NCR. Si Senator Binay is NCR. I'm NCR. Wala yung NCR director nyo? Asan yung NCR director niyo?
Your Honor, we did
Ba't hindi niyo pinapunta? Oh,
because we were told to do the briefing the central office.
We're supposed to organize the committee. Dapat naandito lang kayo. Very mabait nga lang ako at hindi sumipot ang inyong secretary. Pero sa organization ng committee, dapat naandito kayo lahat.
Madam Chair, our secretary is currently
at ASEAN. Okay nga, mabait nga ako. So okay lang sa akin ng USEC. But yung NCR director mo, dapat naandito yon. Puro kami taga-NCR. Eh. Dadating si JV, taga-NCR din yan. Babuntay mo dito.
We'll call him, Your Honor.
Alam mo, dun sa Tondo, ang dami-dami nyo si, dun sa Baseco, hindi yung Tondo. Ang dami-dami yung CCT beneficiary. Ako na andon. Every week yung tao namin nag-andon, naghahakot ng basura. Dahil walang maghakot ng basura. Kasi nagtatanim kami ng mangrove para wag sila tamaan ng typhoon surge. Pag nag-typhoon surge, nag-garden kami doon para may livelihood sila doon. Nagdumadating doon ng BIFAR para turuan sila sa aquaculture. Ang problema, sasabihin nyo that you're concerned with health and education, yung mga CCT nyo. Eh, ba't pag naglalakad ako doon, walang toilet doon. At ang nilalakaran ko, mga human waste. Yung ba, itinuturo nyo, yung sinasabi nyo, health and education, katakot-takot ang CCT beneficiary nyo doon. Yung ba, itinuturo nyo, ano ba yan, bibigyan ng pera, walang pakialam kung ano gawin nila. Bakit sila walang toilet at doon sila tumatais sa kalye? Ganun ba programa nyo? Sasabihin nyo sa akin that the World Bank demands that there will be sanitation, health, ano, ganun. Eh, naandun ako eh. Kayo siguro, hindi kayo napunta dun eh, kaya hindi nyo alam eh. What is your program on the ground? Shock na shock ako dun. Nagawa ako ng kalye. Dati wala silang kalye doon. Ako nagpagawa ng kalye doon. Kasi nahirapan na ako maglakad. Paglalakad ako doon, natatapakan ko mga human waste. Wala silang toilet doon. Yun ba ang inyong CCT? When you say to me that health and education, yun ba? Wala. Walang nagtuturo doon. Ano yun? Binibigyan nyo lang ng pera? Hindi nyo tinuturuan?
Currently, ma'am,
there every month, my people go there 3 times a week. Nagtuturo kami ng aming urban gardening at pinag-program ko BIFAR doon aquaculture, at nagtatanim kami ng mangrove doon. Nasaan kayo? Hindi ba yun ang trabaho nyo? That's the poorest part of ano. May walang toilet dun eh. Hindi ba part of your program yun? Paano ngayon sasabihin nyo na yung CCT nakakatulong sa mahihirap? Eh, ba't ganun dun? Mo, yung NCR director mo. Kasi tayo, hindi tayo magre-report dito na mga kung ano-anong ganyan, tapos on the ground, ganun ang implementation nyo. Hindi ganun. Pag tayo gumagasta ng 78 billion, there should be better condition on the ground. Ha? 78 billion? Bakit? Pinupulot ba yung 78 billion? Hindi nyo ba alam kung gano'ng karaming pera yung 78 billion? Ba't gano'n na implementation sa ground? Kayo ba? Nakapunta kayo sa Baseco at nakita nyo ang buhay ng mga tao doon?
Yes, ma'am. I was able to go to where the coal plant, But of course, since we just came in, we just assumed, so we're just here for more than 2 months. But
Nakita mo yon?
Yes po.
Okay. And they said it's not the worst in Manila. Yung anot pangalan ng isang mas worst po, Islam Puteng Bato is worst. Oh, hindi ko na nga malaman gagawin ko dun eh. Ang basura doon, nanggagaling sa mga tao, nanggagaling pa sa Manila Bay, nagsasabay sila. Isang galing sa ocean at isang galing sa mga tao. Yung aking project doon, napapagitan ng dalawang tambak na basura. No? Doon. Oh. And ako, in my personal capacity, ako nangungulekta ng basura doon. Oh, my goodness. And then 78 billion ang CCT natin, walang magawa doon.
Madam Chair?
Yes?
Gusto ko lang itanong because di ba you're introducing yung pagbibigay ng bigas on top of the 78 billion. Ano ba to yung actual bigas? Or bibigyan niya lang sila ng rice allowance? Kasi kung bibili kayo ng bigas, di ba makakatulong sa mga farmers natin kung dederetso yung DSWD at kayo mismo yung bibigay ng bigas sa kanila. I think makakatulong to dun sa problema natin.
Okay. Actually, nasa study stage po kami. At kahapon, in fact, nagkaroon po ng meeting together with DAR, NAPSI, DA, NFA. So, nasa study stage po. Kasi kailangan pag-aralan din yung admin cost. Kasi hindi pwedeng napakalaki noong admin cost. So, may mga pinag-aaralan pong possibilities. For example, yung rice voucher.
Asay Karabi, ano ba to? Will it be on top of the 78 billion or will it be part?
It is included. It is included po.
Included. So, hindi to madadagdagan ng budget?
Tama na po siya doon sa proposed budget.
Madam,
Your Honor, next year pa huyan may implement. Yeah.
May I just put forward some of the initial discussions as the ASEC Malu mentioned a while ago. Yesterday, we just had the first meeting with the officials of Department of Agriculture, NAPSI, NFA, and the DSWD. We were oriented by DA that they are developing the LGU corporate farming, wherein the LGUs will be capacitated and assisted by the DA for them to organize the farmers who will be the one to produce the requirement for the rice subsidy. And the LGU, we will procure from the LGU the harvest of the farmers so that the income of the farmers will be increased. So wala po kaming tinitingnan dito na admin cost because yung pong ang LGU po ang tutulong sa mga farmers nila na mag-produce ng requirement po ng ating 20 kilos per family per month. And this will, the Senator is correct po, this will start in 2017.
Halimbawa, ang LGU is nasa cities, wala silang rice land. So they will tie up with an LGU na may rice land. At kaya yung sinasabi nila na yung Quezon City ang magpi-finance ng pagpatatanim ng palay sa Mindoro. Ganun ba yun?
According to the DA officials that were present yesterday, ipapilot po nila sa apat na areas muna ngayon. Yun po ang sinabi nga nila, yung Quezon City, sa Mindoro. Pero ang gagawin po yata ng next meeting namin ay imamap natin. Nasaan po yung distribution ng pantawid? alin naman po yung mga rice producing, kasi po dun sa scenario, may mga provinces, municipalities po tayo na rice producing, baka yung requirement ng pantawid sa area na yon kaya nilang isupply at may excess pa sila, yung mga non-rice producing, yun naman po ang aayudahan. But the bottom line here is, hindi po tayo bibili sa traders kung hindi dun sa produce ng mga farmers na i-organize po ng ating DA with the DILG and LG.
Ngayon, itinatay up nyo ang inyong pantawid sa agriculture.
Opo.
Yun ang tinatanong ko sa inyo.
Nga po. Kaya
lang mag-change na kayo ng model na itatay up nyo sa production. We should not agree that you should give additional money for rice. They will not buy rice. They will just spend it for other things.
Yes, ma'am.
Kaya yun ang sinasabi ko sa inyo, that there should be a better model.
Yes, ma'am.
A better model than that. Kasi yung ginagawa nyo, isinasanla lang yung ATM eh. Hindi nyo tinuturuan yung mga tao magtrabaho eh. Hindi nyo tinuturuan magtrabaho eh. Yung mga nadidinig namin, yung mga iba na nasa city, umuwi na. Kasi pag hindi sila umuwi, they will not be entitled to 4-piece. Imagine, pinagpapalit yung trabaho nila sa city sa 1,500. Tinuturuan natin huwag magtrabaho mga tao eh.
Oh. Just to make sure, Madam Chair, Yusek Villar, ano talagang hindi nyo ibibigay yung rice allowance? Wala ko talaga sa programa nyo yung rice allowance na cash.
Wala po. Sa design so po at sa instruction po ng Pangulo at ni Secretary Judy, this has to be received by the pantawid in the form of rice. Ang 20 kilos nga po per month. We will start in January. At ang ine-explore po namin, ayun nga pong tie-up with a DA na yung pong corporate farming para ang mapalakas po natin dalawang aspeto. Yung pong kinikita rin ng mga farmers natin, maialis sila dun sa 5-6 na hindi pa naaani, nakabaon na rin sila sa utang. So yun po ang mga tinitingnan. And at the end po, in the form of price, alam po namin din na kapag binigay mo ang pera, hindi po assured na ibibili ng bigas. So dito po talagang bigas. Ang tinitingnan na lang po namin dito yung pagkuha, distribution. Kasi alam po natin na ang mga pantawid natin hindi naman po nasa poblasyon lahat. So yung pong pag-uusapan namin sa susunod, first meeting lang po kahapon, yung pong spread nga, kung nasaan manggagaling ang bigas, nasa, yung supply and demand na pag-uusapan, and then the distribution. Pero klaro din po kami, walang admin cost kasi yung pag-compute po namin noon ay ang LGU po ang aming pagbibilhan at hindi po any trader. Ang aayuda po sa LGU ay yung DA at ang LGU po ang mag-organize dun sa mga farmers natin who are underground. Hindi po tayo we will not rely on the traders para po sa farmers mapunta itong ating programa.
So you're saying that out of the 78 billion, 21 billion now will be tied up with agriculture?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yung sa rice distribution, rice
discuss.
Subsidy.
Yung livelihood program nyo na 10 billion, saan nyo dinadala yon?
Also, Madam Chair and Senator Binay, we also have, the department has the Sustainable Livelihood Program. And basically, this has, can we show the two tracks? There are two tracks that, one is micro enterprise development and the other one is employment facilitation. Okay. So there are currently, the existing practice is that the pantawid families are organized into SLPAs or Sustainable Livelihood Program Associations. No? So together, they identify projects and the model, just. But of course, per individual, if it is an individual, the maximum amount is just 10,000. So if it is SLPA as an organization, as a group, the money becomes bigger. So it's a...
How much?
Depending, so the grouping could vary, but on the average, it could be anywhere between 10 to 20... thousand, yes, ma'am, per individual. Okay, can we show the slides that yung process. Manu, so the SLP process, of course, there's an area identification where priority areas are identified based on the existing opportunities and the capacity or resources to possible participants in the area. And then we go with participant identification. So participants are identified based on their capacities or resources as well as their location or proximity. Okay. Existing projects. Wala po sa slide, ma'am, but we can, it's in the briefing paper.
Your last budget, magkano yan? Yung livelihood, magkano yan? 10 billion ngayon eh, before?
Your Honor, yung 2016.9.6, yung pinopropose for 2017, ay 9.2 billion. Oh,
pero nung last year, it's 4 billion. O, saan pumunta yung 4 billion? I want to see.
Can we show some examples?
Doon pumunta yung 4 billion.
What are the enterprises or...
ano ba yan? Dinidivide nyo by region, by province, by towns? O, ipakita mo sa akin yung listahan ng mga binigyan nyo na region, province, town. And bigyan mo ng example ako, pipili ako doon sa listahan mo kung ano ang gusto kong i-discuss mo.
Madam Chair, siguro habang hinahanap nila, yung doon ho ba din sa 4 million yun na household? Ano to? 100% coverage na tayo nationwide? I mean, all cities and municipalities may beneficiary tayo.
Yes.
So 100%.
Yes. Except in Batanes.
Wala silang pahirapan do, kasi kung bigyan nila ng budget ang Batanes, 16,000 people, 15
na cover lahat. So sa Batanes, no, may
poverty incidence po doon, pero mapakaliit po ng population
hindi,
na kaya na po
na
nila.
So wala kayong beneficiary sa Batanes?
Pag dinivide mo yung binigay na pera sa Batanes by 16,000 people, yun lang ang population nila, eh pagkayaman-yaman nila doon. Pagkayaman-yaman ng Batanes.
We now ready.
Public works budget lang ng Batanes, i-divide mo dun sa 16,000 people. Oh, wala na. Doon pa lang pagkayaman-yaman na nila. So, wag na natin pag-usapan ng Batanes. Batanes is a non-issue.
We are now ready to account for the 22 billion. The other projects that would... Yeah, that's
start.
Sana ba yun? The PS is 5.3 billion.
Okay, we go overhead.
The overhead for our general administration and support services, that's 572 million.
And then
support to operations, that is 545.
The 1.1.
Yes,
ano
your
total? 1.1.
Yes, your honor.
Okay, 1.1B. Okay.
Yes. So the other 22 billion that you're looking for are the following.
Okay.
The our formulation and development of plans and policies, we have 49 million.
Policies and plans.
Yes.
Is
our social technology development, 67.3 million. Oh. Our monitoring and evaluation of bottom up budgeting projects, 24.1 million. Mm. Our provision of services for center-based clients, this is for our centers and institutions, 1,406. 1,406
ano
million.
Yung services to?
Centers and institutions.
Services to center, ano ibig sabihin nun?
We have 71 centers and institutions which caters residential care for our abuse.
Sino to? Ano example nito?
Ito yung Heaven for Women.
Ano? Ano
Haven
pangalan?
For Women. Mga Haven for Girls.
Yung mga ano. Oh, yeah. This is yung for for child for ages 1 to 7, mm-hmm. 7 to 17, mm-hmm. 18 to ano, and then senior citizen. Okay, mm-hmm. 1.1 billion. Bakit ilang ba to lahat?
71, ma'am.
71, so ang isa, magkano ang isa?
Iba-iba, ma'am, ang budget
hindi
niya.
Nga, kasi magkano ang isa? 71 divided by 1.1B. Ilan yun? Hindi, magkano isang facility on the average? You spend 1.1B sa 71 centers, o the 1.1B divided by 71, magkano?
That's 19,780,000.
Okay, 20 million each.
Yes,
okay, sige, go ahead.
Our assistance to PWDs, mm. and older persons, that's 12,189,000.
12 million lang yan, ha?
Yes, Your okay. Honor. And then we have program management and monitoring, 60,310,000.
60?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay.
And then we have protective services for individuals and families in especially difficult circumstances. That's 3,597,000.
3 billion?
Yes, Your Honor.
As ino to?
Ito yung ating assistance to individuals, yung mga humingi ng mga tulong sa Boreal.
3 billion?
Yes, Your Honor. That 3 billion? Is for the whole region.
Oh, yan. Kasama yung Boreal assistance. Diyan ba yung Boreal assistance?
Transport.
Pag-uuwi na sa probinsya.
Hmm. Ba't hindi namin to nararamdaman? Kanino nyo to binibigay?
How do you decide that 3 billion?
Hindi, ako kasi, okay lang sa akin yung mga sinasabi mo, mga 12 million, 60 million, 20 million, pero 1.1 billion at saka 3 billion, eh, medyo re-reviewin natin ano ba yung 3 billion.
Your Honor, yes. If I may, the protective services programs consists of two...
Yan ang gagaling yun sa Congress, 300 times, magkano ba binibigay nyo?
Ma'am, it depends on the
pero
number
more
of...
more or less.
This is on demand basis, so...
Hindi nga, more or less. Each individual, 10 million, 20 million, ano... Sige mo sa akin, average, para ma-accountan natin yung 3 billion. Huwag na tayo magtagal dito. Okay lang naman sa amin yun eh, because that's okay, pinamimigay naman nila sa mga tao. O ano, 300 times what? O, ilan doon?
Ma'am, it's an average of,
sige, okay
more or less
10
to 11 in.
Go ahead. Okay.
So, the program consisted of two components. One is the individual's assistance to individuals
okay
in crisis.
Okay na ako. Naintindihan ko na yung 3B. Tuloy na tayo. Yes.
For supplementary feeding program, we have 3,427,000.
Sino naman yung nagpipiding? Sa daycare?
Children.
Ah? May nakita ka ba sa daycare mo? Ilan daycare center to? Hindi. Marami kaming daycare. 30. Oh. Wala akong nakita nito sa daycare ko. Ilang daycare? Eh, kasi... Congresswoman to, kaya alam ko yan. So, ilan daycare ang binigyan nyo ng 3B? Ilan? 50,000, how much each? Okay. Eh, ganito talaga ang oversight. Nagsusuma. Nambubusisi. Okay. 3B. Ilang daycare center? Magkano isang daycare center? Para pag sasabihin ko doon sa daycare center ko, humingi sa inyo. Pwede naman. Entitlement nila eh. Bakit ba? Oh.
We reached the presence of Senator JV here. Sito. Senator JV, would you want to make a comment? Okay lang. Oh. Makikinig tayo, mamimili tayo dito sa...
Ma'am, more or less, there are 56,376 daycare centers, which we termed now as child development centers nationwide. Average po of 61,000 po per daycare. Yes, ma'am.
Your Honor, the next... Ang ano lang dito, malalaki, 1.1B, 3B, 3B. Yes. 7B ka pa lang, iho.
Recovery
hinahanap natin.
Yes,
okay.
Recovery and Reintegration Program for Trafficked Persons, that's 24,827,000. We have a national community development-driven project, Kalahi Seeds.
Kalahi Seeds. Oh.
Yes.
Magkano to?
10,729,000,000.
Oh, ano ibig sabihin nito? I-explain mo to. Malaki to. Okay.
Mm-mm.
Bakit hindi mo nilagay sa program yung Kalahi Seeds na 10 billion? Ba't naandito yan? Yung mga more than 1B, dapat nakalagay ito sa program. Hindi dito.
Oh.
Yung mga miscellaneous na yung maliliit. Isama natin to sa program, okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, itong services to center institution, 1.1B, protective services, 3B sa daycare, tapos tong Kalahi Seeds, 10B, okay. Sa, yes. Sa ano to? Ano to? Explain mo to. Isama natin to sa program, ha? Mm-hmm. Hindi to kasama dito. Miscellaneous dapat dito.
NCDPP.
Malaki to eh, 10B. Ano ba yung Seeds Kalahi?
Ito po. Okay, this is...
Yung ba yung livelihood mo o iba pa?
Iba pa yun.
Oh?
So 20B na ang livelihood?
Ay, iba po yung... Ito po yung pagkoconstruct ng mga facilities sa community through the community-driven development approach. So for example, our daycare centers, local access roads, hanging bridges, multi-purpose halls.
Walang toilet dito.
Meron din po, ma'am.
O, bakit hindi ka nagtayo ng toilet sa ano?
Kasi po ang, okay, ang Kalahi Seeds po ay ang focus ay rural areas.
Ito naman.
So, yun po yung...
Hindi ba nakakahiya naman na yung ating mga community sa Metro Manila walang toilet? Diyos ko naman. Alam nyo, nung kumuha ko ng award sa UN for my processing of waste, for my processing of waste, of river waste, ang kasama kong kumuha ng award, taga Durham, South Africa, ang kanyang project is building waterless toilet. Pinagtatawanan ko siya eh. Kasi sabi ko, ano ba yan? 20th century, ang project mo, building waterless toilet. Bakit? Wala ba kayong toilet doon sa South Africa? Tawa ko ng tawa. Pagdating ko sa Baseco, wala silang toilet eh. Di pinagtawanan ko sarili ko. Shock ako. Nawala silang toilet. Tapos sasabihin mo sa akin, mabuti nga sa rural areas, malaki ang lupa. Pwede silang maghukay doon at tumais sila doon sa ilalim ng lupa. Sa Baseco, natatapakan ko yung kanilang mga human waste doon. Pag dumadaan ako doon, nagkalat sa kalye. Tapos sasabihin mo sa akin, sa rural areas nyo gagawin ng toilet. Tama ba yun? Sabihin mo doon sa NCR director mo, mag-build siya ng toilet sa Baseco, bigyan niya ng lahat ng toilet, yung mga bahay sa Baseco, para doon sila mag-uu. Huwag sila mag-uu sa kali eh. Di ba nakakahiya yun? Ha? Pumunta kayo doon sa Baseco at sa Islang Puting Bato at lagyan niyo ng toilet lahat ng bahay doon. At walang tubig. Kaya ewan ko, mag-build nga tayo ng waterless toilet. Kasi sa Durham, South Africa, nagbu-build sila ng waterless toilet. Ewan ko kung ano yung pinambubuhos nila. It's solid eh.
Sinabi niya, nanalo siya for that. So maybe you should discover that kasi wala rin tubig sa Baseco. Alam niyo ba mga bata doon, naliligo sa Manila Bay. Kaya sila, walang malinis na bata doon. Kasi yung Manila Bay, pagka dumi-dumi, eh doon sila nilulubog. Nandun din yung mga uu nila sa Manila Bay. Tapos sasabihin nyo sa akin, 10 billion, Kalahi Seeds.
Your Honor, could we provide additional information for the
Kalahi Ano pa yung Kalahi Seeds? So, this is infra. Infra ba to?
Actually,
infra to communities to improve the lives of communities. Tama ba yun?
Actually, the Kalahi Seeds program is a capacity building program to assist the communities and LGUs facilitate the participation of communities in project activities.
Like what? Sabi mo, building infrastructure, toilet, ano ba yun? Yung mga sinasabi nila.
Actually, Your Honor, that's the outcome of the program because we allow the communities to decide for themselves what program should they take that would benefit
Kung yung community, hindi nila naiintindihan what's good for them, papabayaan mo sila na gawin yun?
Before we do that,
may community kami sa Las Piñas nag-relocate ako naiwan puro human waste. Ako nagdakot ng human waste nila doon.
Unfortunately,
hindi nila minamind kasi yung mga mahirap, akala nila yung human waste nila hindi nakakadiri yun. Kaya nauu sila in public.
In the communities that are covered by our NCDDDB program, we prepare them and help them assist to plan what programs best what are best for them. For example, when they thought that their children ay lumalakad ng mahaba bago makarating sa eskwelahan, the community decides na magpatayo ng eskwelahan, for example, in their community. So actually, we allow them to participate in the planning process of the program. So yung small infra projects is just the result of their...
So this is a small infra project.
Yes, Your Honor.
Madam Chair, paano ito, Yusek? Yung community organization yung magsasubmit sa DSWD na ng proposal and then you do a study kung feasible ba, kung okay ba yung project?
Ang system...
Or is it the other way around? Is it yung DSWD pumupunta dun sa community? Tapos sinasabihan niya, mag-organize kayo kasi parang may pagkukulang sa ganito tapos bibigyan namin kayo ng pondo para gawin ito.
Kasama po sa process, Your Honor, the DSWD goes into the poor communities and assist them and organize them. And then we help them we organize them and to have them assess their communities kung ano yung kailangan pa nilang mga projects to na makatulog sa kanila, no? So we allow them to decide for themselves. So the community decides, nagbubutuhan sila yung mga community members kung ano ang proyektong mas magaganda sa kanila. So pagkatapos nilang ma-finalize yung kanilang programa, mayroong assembly lahat ng barangays and they will vote for themselves kung ano yung priority sub-projects na kanilang unahin.
So yung ba may social worker ka doon. Tapos nag-decide yung community na iyon. Pero tingin ng social worker, hindi naman yun ang dapat. Wala kayong to influence them to do good things rather than to do yung petty things. Kasi alam mo, may chance din na yung mga tao pipiliin nila hindi naman for the benefit of the community. Baka for alam mo na yung mga tao minsan selfish din sila. You don't control that. Hindi walang kuwa doon. Kung ang pipiliin nila useless projects. Meron kayong listahan ng project na pwede lang piliin. Nasaan yung listahan na yun? I want to see that listahan.
I will provide you the menu for projects.
Menu? Nasaan yung menu?
Oo.
I want to see the menu.
Siguro, Madam Chair, since yung kalahisin, so di ba 2003 pa to, how much have we spent for this program? And can you submit to the committee yung list of projects since 2003, siguro hanggang 2015, na na-implement ng Kalahisids program?
Yes, Your Honor, we'll submit the list of projects, of sub-projects that have been implemented in the communities with the menu and the
act. Meron bang toilet doon sa menu?
If the community chooses that.
Meron menu eh. You meron, just choose sa menu.
Kasama po ang...
O bakit yung social worker mo doon sa Baseco, bakit hindi nagtayo ng toilet doon?
Kaming kalahisid sa Baseco po.
Bakit? Baguhin natin yan. Pa paano na kami sa urban na wala kaming toilet? Hindi nyo kami bibigyan ng toilet?
We are piloting urban kalahi po.
Sige. Ilagay mo yan. Opo. Ano na yan? Ha? Hindi pwede yung kalahisids na rural. Dito nga sa urban nang ang dumi-dumi.
Oo.
Pero you said yung kalahisids...
Paano na yung mahirap sa urban areas? Hindi nyo na take care of?
Hindi ho utang, wala hong utang tong kalahisids, no?
Actually, utang din ano talaga ito, yung Foreign Assistance Project ito, World so, Bank and ADB.
Magkano utang
dito? Mm-hmm.
Alam ko nga utang
dito. Ano? Sa ADB po ay $450 million.
And eh, 20 billion ng 450, 10 billion at, lang to.
Ito, meron pa nga po yung World Bank. So, it's World Bank and ADB.
Hindi nga. 10 bilang to. Sabi mo, utang $400 million, that's 20.
Yes,
sobra pa yun. Ano?
The amount is spread in 6 years.
6 years. So, 20B in 6 years. So, 3B. O, 30% nito. Yung ano, sabi mo 20B. Oh. So inutang mo lahat.
Pumam yan in 6 years and started
then,
in
what are we talking? 10B spread in 6 years or 20B spread in 6 years? Sabi mo $400 million eh. Ano?
10 billion po.
So for $200 million spread in 6 years.
Million po ay for this year, ma'am. For 2017, ma'am.
Eh, di lahat to utang. 10B, eh.
Almost all the program cost is about 80% financed by loan. And
also, 8B.
No, mayroon tayong counterpart na
20%.
Mga ganun na nga.
So 8B ang inutang dito.
Mm-mm.
8B is a loan. 2017.
80-20. Yung GOP po nam ay 9.3 billion.
Mm.
Tapos yung...
So may menu to. Okay. So you have enumerated 1 billion for ano, yung centers.
Yes,
3B so. For... yung ano, grants.
Yes.
3B for feeding,
yes,
ng daycare. And then 10B for seeds kalahi. So you have accounted for 17B of the 22B.
Meron pa po, Your Honor.
Ano pa major?
Provision of technical advisory.
Kung maliit lang, pag million-million lang, huwag mo na.
756 million.
Yun, malaki. Oh. Ano yan? Technical, ano?
Provision of technical advisory assistance and related services to local government units.
Ang laki naman yan.
Oo.
750 million? Million?
Yes,
provision
that's for 16
regions,
ma'am.
Technical assistance to LGU?
That is for 17 regions. And then...
ano ginagawa niyan?
Could you...
Diba overhead yan?
That's not overhead, ma'am. Actually, this is...
overhead. Tingin ko, personnel yan. Training.
Mga capacity building activities.
Diba overhead yun? Sige.
Hindi po saan.
Ano ginagawa nun? 756 million. Explain mo lang sa amin kung ano ginagawa nila. nag-accounting tayo. 756 million. Ano ginagawa nun? Just one example para may idea kami how it is done.
Ano po, isang example po ay yung assisting them to be functional MSWDOs. So the functionality of the local social welfare and development office, ma'am. So kasama po dito ay ang capacity development and assisting the... Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Hindi po. Local po. Local,
local po ito. Local. Yes, ma'am. Opo, that's part of, ano to, part po ng devolution.
Towns and cities, 1,500. O 756 million divided by 1,600. Divide nyo nga. Okay, para alam lang natin bawat bayan, ilan ang binibigay nyo.
Mayroon pa po tayong assistance to victims of disasters and calamity.
Hindi na, ito lang, pinadidivide ko sa iyo. Yung 756 million divided by 1,500. LGUs. Oh. Gusto ko lang malaman on the average, magkano binibigay mo?
504 million.
Hmm?
756?
756 million divided by 1,500. Oo. Oh. Magkano?
That's 504,000.
Oh, half million a year for every local government. Ha? 500,000 for every local government. Tama ba yun? Okay. Okay, we go. So, 756 million. Ano pa?
We have
assistance 18 to, na tayo. Okay.
Assistance to victims of disasters and calamities.
Okay.
That's 1,390,000.
Disaster and calamity assistance 1.1B. Oh.
1.3B.
O sige, di ano na tayo? 18, 19. Okay, ano pa?
We have national household targeting systems.
Yung system nyo?
Yes, 122 million.
Ah, maliit lang yan.
Mm-hmm.
Ano pa?
Dali lang po.
Laking pa tayo ng... 18, 19B, o oh, di may 3B pa tayong i-account.
Madam
oh,
Chair,
yan?
Yung 122 million, every year ho yan.
Which one?
Yung
targeting? 22 lang.
Ah, 22.
Hindi ba 22?
122.
Ah, 122.
Every year ho yan.
Opo, especially sa maintenance year. Pag nag-conduct po tayo ng household assessment, kagaya ng 2015, we asked the Congress to give us the supplemental budget na 1.9 billion kasi yung ating in-enumerate po last year is 15.3 million households. So ito pong 122 million is the maintenance budget in years na wala tayong nationwide assessment. 70% po nito ay ginagasta para po doon sa ating mga information technology officer who maintains the database in the 17.
So bibigyan mo kami ng database. Ikaw ba gusto mo database? Kasi na humihingi kami yung listahan ng pantawid nila. Bigyan mo kami lahat. Baka gusto niyo bigyan lahat ng senador. Nang tigi-tigi sa computer, nandun yung listahan niyo ng beneficiary niyo.
Program.
Hindi.
Actually, na, I think, Madam Chair, iba ho yung database diba? For pantawid, iba pa yung national, di ba? Because yung national, yung buong programa niya is based on that database, right?
That's the bigger database po, yung listahanan, which includes the non-pantawid.
Actually, Madam Chair, we're talking about dalawang database ito eh. Yung pantawid programa, tsaka yung national targeting.
Yeah, yeah. Basta yung mga listahan nyo, gusto namin makita. Bigyan mo kami lahat na senador ng listahan nyo. Sa mga room natin, no? Oo, para pag maghahanap kami, mahahanap namin. Kasi ganyan ang ginawa na ako sa PhilHealth eh. Hiningan ko yung listahan nila. Pag may nahingi sa akin ng medical assistant, hinahanap ko doon sa listahan nila. Pag nasa listahan ng PhilHealth, kasi hindi nila pinamimigay PhilHealth card nila eh. Ayaw nila sabihin sa mga tao para hindi magamit. So ako ngayon ang maghahanap, tapos pupuntahin ko sila sa ospital, point of care sila doon. O makukuha nila yung PhilHealth card nila. So ngayon, pag may humihingi sa amin ng ano, eh, national targeting system, nasa listahan ka pala ng ano, eh, CCT, eh, pumunta ka sa DSWD, o, doon ka manghingi ng tulong.
Oh, just to inform you, Your Honor, oh, yung kung database
kasi alam
nyo,
bakit kami ang pipilahan ng mga tao when you have this kind of budget? Oh, bilyon-bilyon ng budget, ba't kami pipilahan ng tao? Di dapat sa inyo pumila mga tao. Diba? Ituturo namin sa inyo, titingnan namin yung listahan nyo. Eh, nandito ka, pumunta ka sa DSWD, you're entitled because you're poor. Diba? Oh.
Pero hindi naman kayo nag-overlap with Philippine Statistics Office?
Hindi po. Actually po, ang Philippine Statistical Authority hindi po nagre-release ng names and addresses. Kaya nga po, tayo nagkaroon ng National Household Targeting System for Poverty Reduction. Kasi po, kailangan, pag nagtatarget tayo for programs and services, may names, may addresses. Mm. Kagaya na sinasabi ni Senator Cynthia. Mm. So, kung punta ka sa Baseco, andun ba si Flor Villar, hahanapin mo. Pero sa PSA po, they remain to be statistics kasi sa mandato po nila, naka-embargo po. They're not supposed to
So, pag binigyan mo ako listahan, hahanapin ko yung lahat ng Baseco, pwede ko silang assemble at makita ko sila lahat. Ah, oh, sabi mo dun sa iyong ano, NCR director, assemble niya, ha? Pakakainin ko. Gusto ko makita lahat yung CCT beneficiaries niya to.
Just tell us, ma'am, when.
Yes, okay. Oh. Okay, we're lacking, ano?
Protective sir, your honor.
19. We're lacking, siguro, mga 2 na lang kasi may mga miscellaneous sila. Oh, budal-budal pa ba? May major pa bang natitira?
Budal-budal na lang mga
Oh, sige. Okay. So, we're accounted for 22 billion. Okay.
Madam Chair, yung sa temporary housing, di ba may ganun kayong program? How much is that? Emergency shelter. Magkano mo yun?
The emergency shelter assistance is part of our quick response funds released to
disaster.
So, the cost is 30,000 per family for totally damaged shelter unit in safe areas, yes, CAS, and then 10,000 po for partially damaged shelter units, but the location should be safe, so that whenever we provide assistance for repair, at least safe din po sila.
Saan ba yun? Protective Services.
QRF po, ma'am. Under the disaster
funds,
we have 1.3 billion for the year.
Saan yun? Ba't wala rito? Ah, doon sa ano, dito, yung major, nilista nila yon. Yeah, here. Ito ba yung ano, assistance to victims of disasters and national. 1 billion lang to eh.
1.3, ma'am. 1.3, ma'am, kanina.
But 1 billion lang nakalagay dito.
1.3, ma'am.
This year, magkano QRF?
Yun po, ma'am, 1.3, Your Honor.
For next year, 1.3.
The issue for next year is that the QRF won't be released directly to the DSWD. It will be a lump sum amount for the NDRRMC under the Office of Civil Defense as its secretariat. So,
ito bago.
Yes, for 2017.
Bagong sistema ho to for 2017.
Yes,
so, hindi nyo na mahahawakan yung QRF.
We're proposing to have the amount returned to us so that we can quickly respond to the requirements of affected local government units.
For 2016, oh, magkano na nagagastos niyo sa QRF?
2015. How much did we spend na? 2015.
So may agriculture na sila ngayon.
Madam Chair, for the obligations that had been incurred as of July 31, we already had 1.033 billion incurred. So every time, the beauty of this one is that every time po depleted na or at a critical amount or level na yung aming QRF, we can request DBM through NDRRMC po.
Ano yung bulk nung ginastosan nyo for 2016 sa QRF?
Part po ng continuing El Nino of last year.
So marami, may mga beneficiary ho kayong farmers.
Yes.
Ilan ho sila?
we can provide you, Madam Chair, Your Honor, but we also have farmers coming from Region 12, Region 6, and even in Luzon. So these are the regions which were declared as heavily affected by El Nino during 2015-2016 El Nino.
Paano yung farmers on naka-receive ng 30,000 assistance?
Not all of them, Your Honor, because this is on need basis. We have the
actual release nyo, ho? Di ba sinabi nyo na ginamit for El Nino?
We have provided cash. For rice assistance po, for farmers, we have accounted for 172.4 million pesos for rice.
Cash po yung, yes. Ano yun, actual pagbigay ng rice or cash
This is the rice, cost of rice released by NFA. We pay the National Food Authority for whatever issued volume of rice. So the farmers will receive the actual rice. Okay, we also have provided the family food packs. These are the viand component to farmers amounting to 232.5 million pesos po. And then for women, particularly the Lumads in the hinterlands of Region 12, Region 11, and even Region 6, we have provided 360,000 worth of hygiene kits. So andun po yung sabon, shampoo, at may mga sanitary pads po. No? So these are expenses for those who had been affected by El Nino. And also we have provided support for cash for work for farmers in El Nino affected areas worth 31.7 million. These are temporary support for livelihood while they're preparing to plant or while their farms had been adversely affected. And then we have also food for work for those na hindi po naka-avail ng rice support.
Madam Chair, may konti po akong katanungan kung medyo tapos na po tayo sa mga numero.
Okay, I'd like to understand a little more about Kalahi Seeds. Kasi sa ano pa lang, sa acronym pa lang, mahirap na, no? Kapit-bisig laban sa kahirapan, comprehensive and integrated delivery of social services. And when you were, yes, infra, basically infra, and then when you were describing it po kanina, Yusek Montano, I get the sense na yung underlying philosophy dito nga is that you consult mismo the community, the people on the ground, kung ano yung mga pangangailangan nila. And that is the same philosophy underlying the BUB, bottoms-up budgeting. So dito sa programa nyong ito, ay nandyan yung BUB concept. Is this part of the BUB? Is this a separate item? Or is it actually the same part of the BUB? Anyone can answer that, please.
Your Honor, that BUB is separate from our Kalahi Seeds National Community Development-Driven Program.
Because the BUB is also anti-poverty.
Yes.
It's also a poverty alleviation program, yes. Correct? And then basically the barangays. But saan ho natin madudraw yung line? What specific services and programs and strictly under Kalahi Seeds and then alin naman yung nasa yung talagang BUB proper under the DILG? I just want to be educated.
Your Honor, I would like to give to you our Assistant Secretary for Promotive Services to explain the BUB and our NCDDP program. Yes, okay.
Actually, BUB came a bit later. So when it started, it is really comprehensive, integrated delivery of social services.
Nauna po itong Kalahi.
Yes.
Kailan ito nag-umpisa?
2003. This is actually initiated during the time of President Ramos, the social reform agenda targeting the 20 poorest 20 poorest provinces.
So that was continued.
That was continued
the Pinoy administration.
Yes, yes. So the concept and the practice and thereby the models were actually evolved, Madam.
Oh, yun, dun lang ako nahihirapan magano because if BUB, pagkakaintindi ko po sa BUB, it's also poverty alleviation and definitely DSWD. Your whole thrust here is really poverty alleviation also. Correct? So saan po natin yan
yes,
na draw ang line?
Senator De Lima, from what I understood when we came in, this is actually an interagency collaboration. So it's not just the DSWD, but it is also the DILG. Who else? DOH. So the design of the BUB, which came in around the time of President Aquino, is operating on that concept that these national government agencies are helping one another in relation to poverty alleviation.
I think, Madam, to correct lang, Asik Harabi, I think yung BUB talaga naging project of the Pinoy administration. More than, it's not really President Ramos because during the time of Pinoy, halos lahat ata ng municipalities nagkaroon na ng project for BUB, whether you're part of the top 20 poorest provinces.
Yes.
Yes, what I understood is when it started, when the model was started and adopted by the DSWD, it actually started during the time of President Ramos as a strategy. So the BUB came after, especially during the time of President Aquino.
Your Honor?
Go ahead.
May I just explain further? Mm-hmm. Ang unang-una pong programa dito ay yung SEEDS, Comprehensive Integrated Delivery of Social Services, which was started as part of the flagship programs namin noon during the time of President Fidel B. Ramos under the Social Reform Agenda. And then we continued, kasi building on this, maganda po kasi ito, empowering the community, and then improving, conducting participatory assessment on the needs of the people in the barangay. So nag-expand po ito into kapit bisig laban sa kahirapan. This was even continued. Kaya lang nga po, ang focus dito is the rural areas natin, kaya wala po yung ating Baseco kaninang pinag-uusapan. So naging, hindi po namin nilalaglag, inaalis yung SEEDS, kasi yun ang kauna-unahan pong strategy dito na in-expand into kapit-bisig laban sa kahirapan, which is still acting on the same principles of community organizing, empowering communities and people. So after naman po...
So are you saying that this is in fact broader than the BUB?
Now, later on po...
Are you saying that po?
Hindi po broader ko, hindi. Ang BUB po came much later, but adopting almost similar principles po. Ngayon, ang BUB po is not a program of DSWD alone. It's a it's a bureaucracy-wide intervention. Focusing on DILG, DOH, or pag DSWD po ang natoka na may BUB project po, ang ginagamit po naming model na strategy is the kapit-bisig laban sa kahirapan, CIDSS.
Okay, so bale, you know, they are actually integrated also. You cannot really treat both of these programs separately or exclusive of one another because there are some lines na kailangan talaga, they meet somewhere and then nai-integrate talaga yung mga specific projects you under, projects new under Kalahi SEEDS and also BUB. And maybe can you include that as part of your submissions, how to explain further these two, especially Kalahi SEEDS in relation to BUB. And if you can also submit to us mga best practices ninyo po sa Kalahi SEEDS. I'm sure there are a lot of best practices to make us further understand yung importance and desirability of this program. Doon naman po sa 4P CCT, it's good to know na wala naman pala talagang balak ang kasalukuyang administrasyon na palitan o alisin yung CCT or 4Ps. Is that correct?
I think
tuloy yung 78 billion, pero sinasabi nila medyo magpapalit ng model.
Yes, so
they have a 20 billion now for rice, which they will buy from the farmers. So may agri component na ngayon.
So that's my next question po. Of course, I know that this administration wants to improve on and enhance the CCT and the 4Ps as a program, as a premier anti-poverty alleviation program. So, pero, in so enhancing, may balak na i-modify, i-tweak yung mga specific coverage. Kasi ang pagkakaintindi ho talaga natin ng CCT, nag-umpisa ho talaga yan ng cash assistance lamang doon sa mga poorest of the poor, and para mapagpaaral nila yung kanilang mga anak, and for as long as they keep their children in school, patuloy yung cash assistance. Kapag humihinto na mag-aral yung mga anak, then that is a ground to cut off the cash assistance. At syempre, nadadagdagan at nadadagdagan yung amount ng cash assistance na yan, depende sa budget, depende sa kakayahan ng gobyerno na ipagpatuloy yan. Now, nabanggit nyo na nga na isa sa mga balak na pagbabago, aside from the suggestion, I understand from Madam Chair na
that's their suggestion that they tie up the 20 million
livelihood.
No, they tie up the 21 billion for rice to the rice farmers.
Okay.
So may tie up na sa agriculture.
Opo. Okay. Now, and I think it's a good idea also to consider enhancing the livelihood aspect of the assistance.
Now, 10B livelihood project for livelihood, bago tayo nag-account siya ng 22B, ine-explain na nila. I want an example of that livelihood project nila na that cost them 10B. Sinisimulan nila, pwede ba natin pakinggan para ituloy
Opo.
Nila?
May isang tanong na lang po ako also about CCT 4Ps. Yung tungkol nga ho sa bigas, ano ba exactly ang balak ngayon? I'm sorry, I wasn't here earlier when you were discussing that. Ano po exactly balak ninyo na i-modify yung CCT dahil a portion of the existing cash assistance ay i-convert sa pagbigay na lang ng bigas? Ganun ho ba? So ibig ho bang sabihin ito, mababawasan yung pinaka-amount mismo ng cash assistance na ibibigay sa isang pamilya dahil yung portion na yan ay mapupunta sa bigas?
No, bigas talaga.
O separate talaga na hindi maapektuhan yung existing amount. Is that it?
Yes, Your Honor. This is on top of the cash assistance.
Okay. Now, since it is on top of the cash assistance, well and good, if it's an additional kind of assistance, correct? Wala ho itong epekto sa magiging coverage ng programa mismo? Wala ho ba yung epekto doon sa ilan ho ngayon ang beneficiaries ng 4Ps at CCT? Kaya ko lang ho tinatanong ito, baka ho, somewhere along the line, since may additional mabawasan yung mga beneficiary families ng CCT, 4Ps, dahil nga doon sa karagdagan na bigas. Ganun mo ba yun?
Senator Dilma, they have increased their budget to 78 billion from 62. So this is in addition.
So in addition. So wala kang epekto yan. Meron mo bang plano o posibilidad na madadagdagan talaga yung number of beneficiaries families?
Could I explain,
yes,
Your Honor?
Go ahead, please.
In the 2016 budget, we have 4.4 million beneficiaries, which are giving cash assistance of 300 per child for education, maximum of 3 children per family. Yes, or 500 pesos for high school students and 500 pesos for health grants for 12 months a year. at present we have 4.4 million beneficiaries in 2017 because of the results of the second assessment of the national targeting system. The results revealed that about 1.3 million families have transcended from being so poor to above a poor level. So
that's an accomplishment.
That's a concrete accomplishment as far as the Pantawid Pamilya is concerned.
So dyan po sa since nadagdagan o binadagdagan ho ang budget sa CCT, so that can very well cover additional, an X number of additional beneficiaries.
Your Honor, could I clarify further?
In
the 2017 budget, originally these 1.3 transitioning in the sense that they have already transcended from the very poor level. The scheme now is for them to be entitled only for the education grants of their children, but not the health grants anymore. No, but they shall continue to be assisted by the other programs of the SWD, like SLP, livelihood program, and the health services from other government.
So yung health component,
wala na yung sa transitioning families. But doon sa 3 million na yon na poor pa, they shall continue to receive the education and health grants plus rise of 20 kilos a month.
Okay, one last question. Yung tungkol po sa QRF, sinabi nyo nga ho matatransfer na sa NDRRMC pero hihirit pa rin ho kayo na ibalik sa inyo. Would we know why this is being transferred to NDRRMC? Bakit inaalis po sa inyo yan? Well, historically, at least sa mga nakita namin sa mga dating kalamidad in the past 6 years, ay isa kayo. Mga social workers are among the first responders in a particular community. Do we know the reason? Kung alam nyo lang po.
I could only suspect that the DBM only wanted to consolidate or centralize it in the NDRRMC. I think that's the only reason for it. No.
Pero hihirit pa rin ho kayo, di ho ba? May I encourage you to make hirit?
Yeah. Your Honor, we are only concerned about how fast that funds could be released to us. So if the present arrangement would have an automatic release system where we could receive the funds January 1 of the year, that's all right for us. Because our only concern is that whenever there is a calamity, we'd be able to do right away so that we could have pre-positioning efforts and the quick response efforts we have for the victims of calamities. Yun lang po ang concern namin. Whatever arrangement, kung ibalik man sa amin.
Hindi ibig sabihin, halimbawa ho, hindi na ho talaga sa inyo maibalik and it really stays with the NDRRMC. Definitely, hindi ho ibig sabihin nito na wala na kayong role mismo dyan sa quick response calamity-related thing. Di ho ba? Kasi mandato nyo pa rin ho yan talaga na tumutulong sa quick response. Only that, since, well, kung centralized, maybe at some point, yun ang magiging problema, the delay. Yes, Asek?
Good morning. I think it is inconsistent with our mandate that we are the first responders. And when it will be transferred to another agency, it will take more another bureaucracy.
So in other words, mahihirapan kayo.
Yeah. So to be clear,
gagawin nyo pa rin. Gagawin nyo pa rin kasi kasama talaga yun sa mandato nyo.
Yeah.
Pero mahihirapan na kayo dahil may dadaanan pang iba bago
Yeah.
makarating sa inyo.
That's right. And we know how bureaucratic works. So we are asking your support for this proposal so that we can have direct access to the funds. And there's room for flexibility rather than to go to another agency and ask. And we don't know what factors. Sometimes we know how difficult for us in the bureaucracy.
Okay, so susubukan ho namin.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. That's all, Madam Chair. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator.
Madam Chair, siguro idadagdag ko lang din. Pero I think nagka-problema ho tayo ng 2015. Parang yung QRFO naging, it was not quick enough. Hindi ba ho? Nagkaroon ng problema ng 2015. I remember si Senator Loren Legarda instructed you to, kumbaga, gastusin nyo na yung QRF kasi I think mga November na yon hindi pa nauubos ata yung QRF or hindi nagagamit during that time. Di ba para nagkaroon ho ng problema kayo sa QRF? Naging medyo slow yung paggamit na itong QRF.
Thank you, Your Honor. Let me just clarify. In 2015 po, hindi po kami nagka-problema sa QRF. What happened is that we requested because of the enormity of the disaster occurrences plus later part the El Nino phenomenon, we requested for augmentation funds as additional amount to support the DSWD. So that's the one that had been a little bit delayed. However, may mga tulong din po yung other agencies na pinaabot sa amin. In fact, to reiterate po our request for giving back the automatic release to the DSWD for the QRF, because we chair as the lead of the response pillar of the NDRRMC, we chair the 11 response clusters of the NDRRMC. Plus, we managed on our own the food, non-food, the evacuation center management or the camp management, and also the protection of the IDP. So that's our concern for the transfer of the QRF from DSWD centralized at the NDRRMC. So it's a very quick mechanism for release, except that for last year, the additional amount was a bit delayed.
Thank you very much. May we recognize Senator JV?
Yes, Madam Chair. Ganda umaga sa inyo lahat. And I just, medyo nababahala lang ako, no? Kasi I've been hearing, no? Medyo, yung part, more than 80% of what we use in the program, so the landed particles sa CCT are loans from World Bank and ADB. Am I correct? Tama ho ba? Mga ilang porsyento?
Seeds kalahi.
But CCT also, mga ilang?
20%.
No, it's only about 12 to 13%.
12 to 13% ang loan?
Yes.
Okay. Ang tanong ko lang, do we, I noticed that the budget of the CCT talagang increased rapidly during the previous administration. Dati kasi ang ano to eh. This is ano to, diba? This is an old program which has been continued pero no panahon ni GMA less than parang 8 billion lang. Tama ba? And then naging when I was in Congress, naging 20 billion, naging 30 billion. Naging 50 billion, ngayon nasa ano ba ko tayo? 78 billion. And I remembered also that the budget of the DSWD itself was about 30 billion lang before. But because of the 34 billion, nama ho, Yusek Montano, and then because of the increase in the UCCT, naging 100, ano ngayon, nasa 100 billion na tayo. No? I just want to ask, do we have any exit mechanism for this program? Talaga ho bang, do we, kung halimbawa, mag-decide ang administrasyon na ito, na itigil na? Oo nga, political suicide. Because doon sa Mexico, alam ko, meron silang ganito, Madam Chair, hindi na sila makalabas kasi magre-revolusyon na ang mga tao. So do we have any exit mechanism just in case this program is ceases to be ano, merong order to be to stop this program?
Right now, Senator Ejercito,
we're studying a strategy. We call it convergence strategy for the transitioning families. The idea of which is eventually we will be able to transition the so-called near families, near poor families into self-sufficiency and self-reliance. So we start from, of course, we want to graduate them. But at this point, their situation is very volatile, vulnerable. So should there be shocks, economic and disaster, human-made or natural, their situation might slide back. So we have to be very deliberate in our efforts, know that in this approach, we have to graduate them. We have the package should include, for example, livelihood assistance, but not just livelihood assistance. It should also look into asset reforms, jobs creation, and provision of relevant social services. So that is the flagship of the new administration of the DSWD that we want to explore and study very carefully so that this becomes a good strategy to move forward to. So.
Siguro nung ano, nung nakita nyo na yung health pwede nyo na bigay sa health, sana pinalitan nyo yung related to ano, agriculture or livelihood. Nung palitan, kasi tinatanggal nyo na yung health, di ba? Titiran nyo na lang yung education, sabi nyo, for 1.3 million families. Sana instead, tinayap nyo na, hindi nyo na dinagdagan yung rice, yun ay pinalit nyo. Para... Ba't nyo pa pinalaki? Pwede na yung babawasin na 1.3 million families na aalsin nyo sa health and very well naman yung DOH can take care of the health. E di sana nilipat nyo yung sa rice para hindi nadagdagan ng budget, para hindi laki-laki ng budget every year. Kasi 60 plus lang last year, ngayon 78 na. Sana in-advise nyo na gano'n.
Yes, because we also want to be very consistent with our messaging. Because if we do that, these people will be right away removed.
It says there you have 1.3 million beneficiary na hindi nyo nabibigyan ng 500 a month na na health kasi nakagraduate na sila. And ang laki-laki naman ng budget sa health, hindi naman napitin dapat. Ako po nagsasabi sa inyo na huwag nyo na i-cover ang health, dapat DOH yun. Eh, di sana yun ang ipinalit nyo sa RISE para hindi na tayo tumaas pa. Oo, di ba? Magkano yung 1.3 million times 500? Di, ano yun? 500 million. Ano? 1 year is 500 times 12, 6,000 times 1.3 million times 6,000.
That's 7.8 million.
Oh, yun. Sana yun ang pinalit nyo dito sa RISE. Ito ang pinalit sa rice, 20B yung rice, di ang dinagdag lang 10B, di something like that. Kasi para may exit mechanism na tayo, hindi natin binawasan kasi talagang tatanggalin nyo na eh. Bakit hindi nyo pa inano yon yung tinanggal yon tapos ipinalit yung rice para medyo naman nag-i-improve tayo. O hindi yung... hindi nyo sinabi nyo mag-exit na based on study 1.3 million people at 6,000 a year kasi 500 a month. Oh, that's 7.8 billion. Di sana dinagdag na lang sa RISE is 11. Oh, di 68 lang ang ating ano pantawid pamilya program, di ba? Eh kayo na rin nagsabi yun ang findings nyo eh. Oh, ba't nyo dinagdagan pa? Ay nako.
Madam Chair.
Tapos sinasabi nyo, may strategy kayo sa exit. Ito na yung exit eh. Because you did a study 2015, 1.3 million, tatanggalin nyo na yung health benefit. Titira nyo yung educational benefit. Di sana RISE ang pinalit nyo. Hindi pa kayo maa-accuse na binawasan nyo, pinalitan nyo ng RISE. And yet, nabawasan natin yung pantawid pamilya program. Oh. So, hindi kayo yun, taon-taon, increase. Di ba?
Madam Chair, siguro ano ba yung magiging thrust for the incoming 6 years? Kasi kung makikita ho nyo yung number of beneficiaries from 2010 to 2015, kumbaga yung programa nag-start sa 800 lang na beneficiary, di ba? Tapos, ngayon 4 million na tayo. So, what is the thrust from 2016 to 2022? Do we add more beneficiaries or taon-taon magbabawas na ba tayo ng beneficiary para mababawasan na rin yung budget?
Okay.
So, what is the policy direction?
I'll answer the first question, which is, are we expanding? So, the answer is, we are not expanding, and that is as per Secretary Benjocno. So, we will retain it at its current level. Number two, what is our plan or what is the thrust of the new administration of the DSWD? The idea mainly is that we want our people, especially our poor people, to become self-sufficient and self-reliant. So we want to graduate them in a deliberate and calibrated way. So this has to be a strategy has to be planned out well. So we do not want, because as you know, it's going to be difficult if we remove them just yet. So there has to be a strategy to actually move them towards that direction. And we have to plan for that.
So we can see a scenario, no, for example, 2018, imbis na 4.4 million beneficiary magiging 3 million na lang, 2019 yung magiging study 2 nila, million na lang.
Yung study nila, you do it every 5 years, di ba? Yung sabi mo 2015, the last study you made is what?
2009.
Oh, 2009. Hindi nga sila every year mag-i-study kasi mahal yon. So, ang latest study nila ay 2015. Under the 2015 study, 1.3 million family, hindi na nila bibigyan ng health grant.
Pero may education pa,
may education pa rin. So, ang health grant, it's 500 a month, 6,000 a year. Kung 1.3 family yon, that's 7.8 billion a year. Dapat binawas nyo na yon, tapos nung magdagdag kayo ng rice, in-add nyo yung rice, di ang budget nyo lang is 70B. Oh. Iyon ang exit. Ibig sabihin, pag nag-aral kayo at minagya kayo, nakita kayong changes, edi baguhin nyo. Hindi baling ano, ito, lumaki rin ang budget nyo, but it's for rice. Nabawasan na yung for health. Di ba? O, ba't hindi nyo ni-recommend yun? Ba't ganyan pa rin ang budget nyo?
Your Honor, that's exactly what we did for 2017. Because our budget for 2016 is 62.6 billion. Our requirement for rice is 23.4 billion. So our minus natin yung 7 billion, so may 16 billion pang increase because of the rice. So that's binawas na po yun, Your Honor. Mm-hmm. So yung ating formula for 2017.
But moving forward, do we see a scenario na yung number of beneficiaries taon-taon, mababawasan kasi kumbaga naging successful na yung program, naging self-sufficient.
May study ba kayo every year? Nang gagawin nyo every year? Every 5 years yata?
Let me clarify that. Of course, as the program, we could actually do monitoring and evaluation. So there are midpoint reviews yearly or even we can make it as frequent. No, we can design it. The listahanan is a separate mechanism to track, to count who the poor is, where they are. So that's the listahanan, that's the national household targeting. But in the case of Pantawid, as a program, given that you mentioned these, we will definitely consider your points and we will make our systems more robust. So in terms of monitoring and how these results are actually fed into our evaluation systems, and part of our strategizing also. So we will be more, deliberate. Okay, and noting the points that the Madam Chair, Senator Villar, pointed out. So we will definitely incorporate that.
I just want to see na yung ano, yung SLP, yung livelihood, yung sample nyo. I just want to see that. Kasi ano yan eh, 10B. Yung 10B, livelihood.
So while waiting for the slide presentation, I did mention...
At saka ang gusto ko makita yung, i-explain mo yung ano, pamana. Yung, yung conflict areas, kasi may tanong ang media na ano ang plano sa mga bata na naipit sa crossfire? Hindi pala to sa droga. Ang question nila is ano, wala ba kayong participation sa drug campaign na binabalak? Habang nagpipresent noon, mga naghahanda doon, ano ang role nyo ngayon sa drug campaign? Okay.
Yusek Cabrera po.
Yeah, Madam Chair, DSWD had been invited to participate actively in the campaign against drugs. There are...
City beneficiary, nalaman na drug pusher, ano, tatanggalin nyo ba sa CCT nyo? Or ano, I'm just asking you, drug pusher, or ano, ang dami-dami nahuli, CCT, tatanggalin nyo ba? Kung drug user, tatanggalin nyo?
Madam Chair, magkano yung budget nyo for yung drug program?
For the current year, Madam, Your Honor, DSWD has no budget for this one. That's why we're sourcing initially because we're helping already some families of former drug dependents and pushers under our assistance to individuals in crisis situation. Now, what happened, Madam? We have 3.3 billion, Your Honor.
Protective.
Yeah, under the protective services. Kukuha po kami ngayon kasi wala talaga sa wala po sa part ng budget for 2016 po ng DSWD. Yes. So, Madam Chair, if I may continue, in the national program to support the ma'am, the DSWD, because there are three clusters or pillars that have been created. Number one is that of center-based treatment and rehabilitation, and this is not under DSWD, this is under DOH. So once assessed that the use is really intensive and the individual would require center-based rehab, then that person will be assisted by the Department of Health. But if assessed not to be using intensively drugs, then the intervention would just be community-based. The one chairing this is the DALG and the church, but DSWD is also a member. Yeah, and the third one, this is the aftercare and reintegration. So when the individual had been rehabilitated from drug treatment centers or even those put in jail because of crimes, then DSWD now will come in together with the local government units and the other agencies. However, right now, even if the individuals have not gone through yet center-based treatment for drug abuse, we already had provided assistance because of some drug users who had been killed. Yung mga pamilya po nila lacked the wherewithal to have decent burial or even to support also family members who are really in need of assistance. So that's where we're coming in now. Doon namin kinukuha yung sa...
Punin yung pera nyo para...
Nandiyan po sa assistance to individuals in crisis under the protective service funds.
Eh, hindi. Meron ang pagdadalhan nitong protective service fund. Hindi pwede yung utang. Maghanap kayo. Magbawas kayo sa iba nyo at dalhin nyo doon. Hindi ganun. Malagot kayo dyan. Hindi pwede yan. No, I'm telling you, kawawa lang kayo. Kami, wala kami pakialam. Hindi kami nahingi dyan sa Protective Services Fund nyo. Pero lagot kayo sa Congress.
Okay, Madam Chair. Going back, no, pwede yung bumalik dun sa kanina dun sa exit strategy. Because ang worry ko lang before, when I was tipping Congress, sabi ko kasi, well, anyway, which way you look at it, itong CCT, it's really a dole out pa rin, no? Maganda talaga yung maganda yung intention, di ba? To put the kids to school. Hindi ho ba mas maganda kung direkta na lang yung billion-billion na ginagamit natin dito, we're spending about 70 billion a year for CCT. For example, 78 billion to be exact. Yung halimbawa for SUCs, we only need about 15 billion. Lahat ng tuition ng mga estudyante na nag-aaral sa mga state universities and colleges, hindi na sila kailangan mag-tuition.
Hindi na mga karating
sa college. Hindi nga, isa lang tong example. And then the others, baka hindi ko kaya pwede dun sa mga direct services, no? That we can do, that we can give. Kasi there's no guarantee that when we give cash kasi ito eh. Madalas naliligaw. Pag may piyesta na, gagamit sa pangpainom, nagbabagamit sa pangpahanda. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, di ba, ilang beses ko sinabi siya, may nag-text sa akin. CCT beneficiary, naku, bago magamit yung pera, pa-uwi, nagamit na sa pagparimand, nagparimand na. Nagamit na sa parlor. So what are our mechanisms? Or if any, to make sure that it is being, meron ba tayong studies na talagang tumaas na yung literacy ng DepEd in the last 5 years that the CCT was increased?
So of course, this is my attempt to answer that. So I'll answer the broad and then I'll answer the specific. So you're asking us about an exit. All right. So that's basically
the preparation lang naman,
yes,
na,
yes,
because
so
we do understand.
Necessarily exit, changing of the model.
Yes, changing, yes, of the model.
But it's good to know that there's a livelihood component,
yes,
na you want to transition.
Of the model. Yes.
But yes, I think I will pick up what Senator, the Madam Chair Villar said. No, it's examining the model. So in examining the model, it's also looking at what is existing, no, elsewhere, but also looking at our own experience, what are the gaps, what there may be successes, and for all these items that I mentioned, we have to be very evidence-based. So we are doing the study, we are doing monitoring, etc. And as I said earlier, we will try to make our systems more systematic and more robust, so that I can assure you, Senator.
Thank you, Rabe. Ma'am, do we have? I understand you're conducting studies now.
Yes.
No? Meron ho ba tayong yung talagang impact evaluation study to make,
yes,
to check if this program is indeed really beneficial,
yes,
to our poor, no?
Yes.
Tanong na lang natin, to bumaba. Kasi ang worry ko rito, yung poverty incidence natin has not really improved much.
Yes.
Meron mang improvement, pero very,
yes,
very slight, very insignificant.
Yes,
no?
Sir.
But with more than 4 million beneficiaries times 5, dapat 20 million of our population is benefiting from this. Pero maliit pa rin yung debt niya sa poverty incidence,
yes,
halos wala.
Okay, I'll try to be very objective but at the same time candid. So there were impact studies done by World Bank as an interested party and by the DSWD also. And these studies, first wave and second wave, pointed out that there are indeed education and health outcomes. However, these impact evaluations did not really touch on poverty reduction because the design of the evaluation study is just measuring really the outcomes. So I think if we want to measure poverty reduction, the design of the evaluation must be reflected. So again, as I understood, this is how I understood the four P's, it is considered social protection vis-a-vis the poverty reduction. So in effect, what are we saying? This is not a poverty reduction measure, but more like an investment to end intergenerational cycle of poverty. So hence, I think for our purpose here, we must be very pointed. We must be very directed that it is poverty reduction that we are really wanting to achieve. So yeah, in our next round of impact evaluation, there's a third wave. We will meet again with our development partners and our researchers.
But who's conducting the impact evaluation study?
Yes, as I mentioned, it's an interested party. So the World Bank is an interested party, but there's
but they do conduct.
Pwede mo nang wag tanggapin yung World Bank, 20 billion lang. Eh, alam mo, kaya minsan nila ginaganyan tayo no, para doon sila kikita doon sa study. Ano ba yan?
Okay, so ano po, I'll qualify my answer. So it is the World Bank funding that, but...
sila na naman ang study. Yes. Magkano binayad nyo sa study?
Maybe Director Leo Reynoso will be able to answer the specifics.
Hindi mo ba napapansin na sila lahat ng study? Magkano yung study? Baka mas pareho lang yun ang binigay nila sa atin. Oh, magkano?
For impact evaluation, it is about 40 million, 30 to 40 million.
40 million ano?
Pesos.
Kala ko eh, 40 million
dollars. We are actually on the third wave, the first wave.
Ibig sabihin yung 2015 study, 40 million pesos.
Yeah, actually,
yung extensive study ng 2015, 40 million pesos.
Yes, the second wave.
Sino gumawa nun?
Actually, it's the DSWD project but it's funded by...
Hindi ba merong gumagawa ng study niyan? Hindi naman marunong sino nagawa?
Actually,
the data collection. Nyo yan
the data collection is being conducted by
kanino
SWS.
Kanino nyo sinab-contract?
SWS, the winning bidder.
Magkano binayad nyo sa SWS?
I have no data, ma'am. But
bakit hindi nyo alam? Nagbayad kayo, hindi nyo alam.
40 million po kasi.
Magkano binayad nyo sa SWS?
Yung total po kasi niya is about 40 million. But when it comes to data analysis, it was conducted by PIDS.
For the whole Philippines?
For SWDS, for data gathering only.
Hindi. Ang 4.5 million na tao, sampling. Hindi rapid assessment. Yung rapid assessment ba yung 2015? No, it's not. It's an extensive study.
What they did is...
Every year nyo, rapid assessment. But the 2015 is an extensive study. O sabihin mo.
Your Honor, the listahanan is an information management system. Ang sinasabi po nila yung impact evaluation, which is different po. We are not the one on top. Yung amin po, ang output po namin is a database so that we are able to tell you who are the poor and where they are nationwide. So yung pong impact evaluation po... Okay. Yung pong... kami po yon. It was not born out of the impact evaluation. It was the national we conducted the 2015 nationwide national household targeting system enumeration po involving 15.3 million households. We spent 1.9 billion po to cover that, and now we have in our database 5.1 million poor. Iyon po ang result, yun pong study nyo ang nagsabi din na 1.3 million households of Pantawid have now transitioned to being non-poor but barely above.
That you cannot do that every year kasi napakamahal, 1.9 billion. Yung rapid nila, magkano yun? 40 million.
40, but it's
that
been conducted.
You do every year, di ba?
Every 2 years.
But that one, that was done after 2009, 2015, 6 years, di ba? 6 years, 2015 at saka 2009, every 6 years, after the almost the end of a president. Kasi 2009, ending Gloria, tapos itong 2015, ending Pinoy, di ba? That is 1.9 billion. Yun ang sinasabi ko, that you cannot do that every year. What you can do every year is that 40 million. Di ba? Magkano binayad nyo sa SWS?
We will check, ma'am.
Madam Chair, 15 million households.
15.3 million households ang ating kinover. Using the PSA classification po ng who are living in rural barangays and urban barangays.
Nagtatanong ako sa iyo, yung bang listahan ng PhilHealth galing sa inyo? Yun yung 15 million ng PhilHealth.
Yung 5.2 million na in-enroll ng PhilHealth under the indigent-sponsored program nila came from our database.
But their figure is they will give PhilHealth card to 15 million families. Kaya 38 billion yon. Saan ang galing yung 15 million? Nang galing sa inyo?
Yung pong aming database ng poor is 5.2 million households.
Pero 15 million
nila. Marami po sila kasi. Yung pong point of care, as you mentioned a while ago, Your Honor, ito po ay mga additional.
Kasi sila nag-add nun, hindi galing sa inyo. Kinuha lang nila sa inyo 5, ano.
5.2 million households.
Eh, bakit sinasabi sa akin nung isang probinsya na they have been telling PhilHealth, binigay daw sa kanilang listahan is 150,000. Yung 40,000 daw mga patay na. Tatlong taon na daw nilang sinasabi sa PhilHealth, napatay na yung paltan na yon. Hanggang ngayon, di pa napapaltan. Bakit ganun?
Not privy to that, Your Honor, yung sa patay. Kasi yung pong aming sa result, buhay po yung mga pinuntahan namin, yung households namin.
So, hindi lahat sa inyo galing yon.
Hindi po siguro. At saka po, you may want to consider how they define yung kanilang enrollees. Kasi po, in a given family, kapag yung pong primary enrollees nila ay yung father, yung couple. Mm. Pero pag may anak po silang above 21, that's treated as another enrollee. So they may have several enrollees in a given family. How much more, in a given household, a household may have one or more families. Mm-hmm. So palagay ko po, linisin lang nila. But I would admit that sila po ang isa sa primary beneficiary po ng ating listahanan because sa indigent program nila, kinukuha po nila ang aming database.
Okay.
Want to continue?
Okay.
Mayroon lang po katanungan, kasi sabi ng COA, sa kanyang audit, no, marami daw ang mga cash grants na hindi pa na-withdraw ng mga beneficiaries. So, gano'n ka totoo ba ito? Ibig sabihin mo, ang may mga marami kang beneficiaries na parang hindi kailangan ng pantawid kasi hindi wini-withdraw. Eh. Pwede, can someone explain this?
Your Honor, as of June 30, 2016, we have 2.3 billion unclaimed grants. Oo. Karaniwan nito ay sa ARM. Because since 2011, it's the land bank who pays the beneficiaries. And the land bank engages conduits to go to the remote places to pay these grants. Ang unang problema natin sa ARM ay yung peace and security problem. No.
Are this, ano kaya itong beneficiaries ito? Hindi kaya ito ghost beneficiaries?
Hindi po naman.
Kasi saan? Marami doon ghost voter eh. Oh. Flying voter.
Mayroon din tayong nasumpungan ng mga...
It's really hard. I understand. It's really a challenge to audit and to check.
Mayroon din tayong problemang ganun din sa ARM. No? Pero itong ating problema ay... yung problema natin ngayon, but hanggang ngayon ay nagbabayad pa tayo nung mga 2011 pa kasi yung ang land bank mayroong problema yung ating mga conduits, no? Halimbawa yung Globe Remit, they have a problem in looking for merchants na gagamitin nila sa pagbabayad doon kasi maraming umaatras na merchants sa pagbabayad because of the security problem.
Paano hindi nakukuha, ano mangyayari diyan?
Nire-reschedule po namin kasi nga...
Ibig sabihin, hindi mo pa lalagay na savings yan? Hindi mahanapin mo
pa yung gano'n?
Kasi andun pa sila, ma'am. Eh. Ang ginagawa ng land bank ay naghahanap sila ngayon. Nakakita na sila ngayon nung conduit na magbabayad. Kaya ngayon, naka-schedule na sila. Patuloy.
Ang laki niyan. Parang hindi ko malaman na... Yung 2.3 billion, mahahanap pa yun. Napakadami niyan.
Accounted po namin lahat yun and presently ay nagbabayad na yung aming mga conduit sa kanila ngayon. Mayroon na tayong cooperative na award ng land bank. Mayroong rural bank na nire-schedule na yung
payment. Previous year, hahabulin nyo pa o dinideclare nyong savings pagkatapos?
Siguro, Madam Chair, para malino ko nyo rin, 2013. Magkano yung hindi
ang
nagamit?
2013 natin, we still have 478 million.
So hanggang ngayon ho, hinahanap nyo pa rin yung 478
andyan million? Po sila, hindi lang makapagbayad kasi nga, nung una ay nagkaroon ng problema, walang makita ang Globe na merchants na magbabayad sa kanila.
Pero it defeats the purpose na.
Diba? Totoo po yun.
May condition yan na pag-aaralin, tapos na yung panahon.
Totoo po yun dahil kasi nga kailangan maibigay agad natin yung assistance. Pero
ba conditional yan on whether they send their children to school or nag-health? Eh, wala na. Tapos na panahon. Eh, ano, paano mo ngayon nila mapufulfill yung condition? Di dapat wag mo nang ibigay, di ba?
Ito pong payroll natin ay compliant na itong beneficiaries. Ang hindi lang natin na ibigay sa kanila yung assistance, kayo ng ating
problema. Pero hindi nyo naisip na itap yung LGU or AFP or PNP na
wala
kayo na mismo yung magdi-distribute?
Kailangan social kasi ang
social worker or hindi ba
wala tayo?
Nasa GAA po kasi na land bank ang magbabayad, hindi ho kami. Nasa GAA po yung
so hindi nyo na-suggest sa land bank na to try that mode? Kunyari,
they have tried it kasi also kasi yung pamagbabayad sila, kung sila mismo, humingi sila ng assistance sa AFP also. But hindi nila makukover lahat kaya nag-hire sila ng mga conduits like cooperatives, rural banks, para ano. But this time, naayos na po ngayong taon yan, naka-award na nila itong pagbabayad sa mga cooperatives na doon na pwedeng meron ng mga merchants na nakukuha doon sa armies mo.
Ngayon, okay, we go there na bagong kabuhayan kasi we have to
ma'am, end
the session by 12.
Can I just finish?
Yeah.
Just two more. So, what are the steps that are being done? Kasi kaso ito talaga, no? Kasi ang hirap maisipin na ganun kalaki ang hindi nagagamit or na-utilize. Baka mamaya, well, I hope. Ano po yung mga steps na ginagawa nyo sa ngayon para maiwasan na itong hindi na withdraw, pero that's 2.3 billion, malaki rin yan.
Yun nga po, nakakita na po ang land bank ng conduit. At ngayon ay ni-risk, nagpapatuloy.
So mababawasan na ito?
Mababawasan na po ito ngayong taon. So, in fact, lahat ito ay nakaschedule ng bayaran.
Kasi kanina sinabi nga, banggit ni Senator Nancy, ba't hindi na lang ang local government units kasi sila ang nasa forefront. They are the... hindi talaga niyan, well, talaga ang gusto ng DSWD noon, ayaw niyo, dapat hindi dinadaan sa local government, tama ho ba?
Hindi po, Your Honor, ang provision kasi ng GAA, ang land bank ko ang mag-decide. Sa kanila dadaan ng pera at sila mag-decide ng pagbabayad.
Pero Yusek, if I remember it correctly, nung nagangampanya kami, meron akong nakasabay si Mayor mag-distribute ng check eh.
Hindi naman, nasasabay lang. Hindi, alam niyo sa ito, Madam Chair, ano lang ako na hindsight, tapos naman ang election eh.
Kasi
pag umiikot kami ni Senator Nancy, no, nakita mo na may kulay namin, hindi na bumalik. Eh, makalaban namin, nagpuputi eh. Anyway, sabi nila, paano kasi may governor nagsabi sa amin, ako paano kayo, mahihirapan tayo dito. Eh, kabibigay lang ng, kabibigay lang ng CCD, kare-release lang. Timing, nandito rin yung kabilang grupo. Hindi, ano kaya yon? Coincidence lang yon? O na-timing lang? Hindi,
tatlong buwan daw hindi nagbigay kasi 1.5, inipon, tapos binigay before election 5,000, di ba? May chismis pang gano'n, kaya nanalo lahat yung mga liberal.
Pwede ho bang, can we call Director Leo to respond to that?
Okay, during the election period, we don't have any payout schedule. Well, ma'am, it's not true because during the election period, wala po kasi tayong payout between May 25 until May 9. So, lahat po ng payout natin ng March, ginawa po natin... Apo, wala po tayong payout. Wala po tayong payout before May 9.
When was the last? Oh, tama.
March, hanggang pong March 24. And then ang kasunod na pong payout natin is after election, May 11.
Kasi may mga allegation nga, no? Based on our experience, that ginagamit daw ng government officials. For example, hindi lang yung release, yung list of beneficiaries. Are we sure that... Meron yung mga allegation kasi, tulad ng listahan ng beneficiaries, minsan daw nakikialam daw ang ilang politiko. We know for a fact that DSWD, nung nag-congressman ako, I was in-house. Ang sabi nun, hindi nila padadaanin sa amin, hindi nila padaanin sa local government unit. Kasi nga, ayaw dapat magkaroon ng political color. Tama ho ba? Ganun, di ba? So the whole time that I was there up to now, yung CCT or 4Ps, hindi ko talaga pinakialaman yan, or never did I appear even in the release of ito sa mga beneficiaries. Kaya lang, paano natin ma-address yung ganong aligasyon na ito yung nagagamit ng ilang officials?
Another clarification, Your Honor, Madam Chair. Naka-cash card po kasi majority na nasa National Capital Region. So wala pong payout yung mga cash card. Apo. Yes, tama po yun.
Going back to San Juan, anyway, itong recent elections, kasi nga, sinabanggit ko sino, the whole time that I was in the House, and up to now, alam ko yung ang CCT, dapat yan, supposedly, wala sanang, as much as possible, walang politiko sanang ma-involve. But this time, in my experience, of course, I have to help my mother, naging very active ang 4Ps na gamit na nagamit. Sino ba ang sa NCR nyo? Kapangalan ni Mrs. Cabrera. Sino ba? Siya na ba? Si Ms. Director Wilma Trinidad, wala na? Ha? Nasa na? Ah, nalipat na. Because that time, she was in NCR. At, hindi ba? Alice Bonoan pala.
Okay. She's now in Central Office po.
Central Office.
For the record, Madam Chair, our Director Vincent Layson from NCR is already here.
Political appointee or part of the career? Are you a career official? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Career.
Bago ka napunta sa NCR, ano trabaho mo?
Sa Central Office po.
Ano national, trabaho mo sa Central
Office? Sa Household office? Targeting Office po, the National Project
okay,
Manager
sige.
Po.
But do you have any employee by the name of Wilma? Baka hindi, hindi ako nagkamali ako.
Wilma Nabiamos? Director Wilma
Director,
Nabiamos.
Yes.
Director for...
Was she involved in the release of the beneficiaries or the 4Ps or any, or the program itself? Like the reason I asked Madam Chair, kasi we want to make sure that in... alam nga natin na political tool to na gamit nung last the CCT program, for us to support this, sana lang maiwasan na natin gamitin sa politika kasi kami nga yung naging kawawa no, pero ay kahit na kami may chance na magamit to, we want to make sure na we remove the political component. It's being used as a political instrument.
May I answer that? Okay, as I've said, moving forward, We would like to ensure that the services directly go to our people, our poor people. Number two, we will also ensure that it will be free from it will not be used for political patronage.
It's easy to say that, but what happened to us? Now, what measures will you be using? Kasi dati, hindi nga pinadaan niya sa office mismo. Kami ang naglalagay ng pondo in Congress. We are the trabaho namin yan. Pero dapat yun, it's stated by law. No? Kaya nga bawal na yung PDAF. Dapat wala nang intervention ang lawmaker. But this time in San Juan, dun mismo nakikipag-coordinate yung inyong CityLink, whoever director that is. Sino ang tawag doon? CityLink. They are coordinating exactly with the office of the congressman. Nagkataon na kalabang namin ngayon. No? Pero... sana lang, both ways. No? Sana hindi tayo na, pera ng pondo yun eh. Pera ng bayan yun eh, di ba? So, ngayon nga, as a matter of fact, there is still a DSW table doon po sa kanilang headquarters ngayon. And they are using this, magbe-release sila ng beneficiary, pero maka na-recall. Tama ba yun? Tignan niyo po yun. Can you please look into that? They are currently meron daw table on DSWD before they release the yung announcement sa 4Ps beneficiary. Kailangan pumirma muna kayo ng recall. Talagang politika-politika yan.
The regional director of field office NCR is here. Maybe he wants to answer that.
Madam Chair.
Please, she may be under you, ng CityLink, whatever, director.
Sa Pantawid po kasi, purely po ATM cards na po tayo sa San Juan, so wala na po tayong cash payout. Baka po dun sa mga assistance to individuals in crisis
situation. Yun na nga po, kasama na rin yun eh. Kasama na rin yun.
But we,
kaya lang ang problema, ang pinalalabas niya, eh ito eh galing kay congressman ganyan-ganyan, dapat walang ganun. Kaya nga natin, di ba, bylaw nga, kaya nga ang pida pinagbabawal, dapat wala na sa intervention, wala nang intervention ng politiko.
Yung congressman susulat lang pero pupunta rin sa DSWD office.
So ngayon po, ganun na po ma'am. Ganun na po ma'am.
Sa office ng congressman, di ba?
Previously po, ganun po kasi yung practice. Pero ngayon po, binalik na po lahat sa field offices na po yung payouts po natin.
Because my congressman, pag may ni-refer siya, magpo-process sa office ng DSWD. Wala naman yung sa opisina niya magpo-process. Bawal yon, di ba?
Tama po ma'am.
If I may share, we already issued Memorandum Circular Number 9. And so this is guiding us in the provision of our protective services. So we are guided by this Memorandum Circular. So basically it says that, you know, that our people can go directly to the SWD. And number 2, referral letters are no longer, while we accept them, they will not be integral to the decision as to the provision of the services, and it will have to be administered by, the assessment should be done by our social worker who is trained to do that after all.
Madam Chair, also, no, what is really bothering is that, you know, nabanggit kanina na meron kayong database, no, yung mga poorest of the poor, at halos lahat na yun din ginagamit ng PhilHealth. Ang nakakalungkot dito, you just have to be careful, no, that you have the database, pwedeng magamit yan, pwedeng mabigay, magmakuha ng politiko, hindi alam nila kung sino bibili nila, di ba? Both ways, meron pang pundo. So, yun na nga eh. So,
asking for the list, so we will know sa aming mambayan, ilan ang beneficiaries, sino ba sila, just so parang ano nila, natin yun eh, parang oversight natin yun kung talaga bang mahihirap sila kasi sometimes nagkakamali din eh, di ba?
So Madam Chief, siguro sa Director Lason, please look into this, yung mga complaints namin, no? Kasi I personally, although kasi sa place, of course, galing sa amin yun, nakarating sa amin yung reports, no? So Madam Chair, I will be filing a resolution to investigate this matter because this is the this should not be because it's already a violation because dapat walang intervention ng legislators, no, sa mga beneficiaries.
Maybe Senator JV, we can ask Director Lison to have a personal conference with all of us. Kasi lahat tayo NCR, so we can talk to you about our concerns in NCR para na lang wala na tayong problema, di ba? So can we request Director Lason to see Senator JV, to see Senator Binay and myself in our office. You make the appointment and then maybe we can discuss our personal concern with you regarding NCR. Yung mga aming gustong malaman tungkol sa NCR kasi we are all from NCR. Okay? Sige, kaya pinapunta ko yan eh para makilala natin at makausap natin kasi marami kaming concern sa NCR. At baguhin nyo na yung inyong ano ba yon? Yung sinasabi nyo na pang rural lang? Kalahi seeds? No. You have to change that. Mag-aaway tayo doon. You include urban. Lagay nyo na yon. Kayo na hindi na kami magbago, no? Magbago na kayo. Hindi tama yon. Okay? So we go to, tapos ka na JV, yun lang. He will see you, JV. Okay? Pwede makipagkita ka kay Senator JV. And so we want to, please explain to us, because we have 10 minutes to go. We have to leave, we have another meeting. Yung kabuhayan.
Sige pa.
So I will ask Edmond, Director Edmond, to present the case studies.
Sige po. Magandang tanghali po sa lahat. So,
yung write-up, gusto ko malistahan ang budget per region, per province, per ano. Wala kayong listahan?
Ma'am,
Yung magkano ginastan nyo per region, per province, per town. Para makita namin, tapos one example, ang haba naman yan, bigyan mo na lang kami ng hard copy niyan. Mahirap basahin. Yung ano lang, yung ano, kasi we have no more time, yung listahan mo lang how you spent the 10 billion.
Sige ma'am. Wala pa kung wala pa po yung sa per province, per town. Pero yung summary po nung budget ng SLP for 2017, yung sa program nito ay 9.2 billion po for 2017. Out of the 9.2, ang grants po rito, yung mapupunta sa beneficiary na program ay 8 billion. Then meron po tayong admin cost na 754.8 million. Ang project po nito, yung sa Sustainable Livelihood Program po, nag-start po ito sa DSWD since 1993, yung Seiya K. Tapos nag-evolve po sa SLP.
Ano yung menu ng project?
Ang menu po ng sa SLP, Sustainable Livelihood Program, ay skills training. Nakataya po kami with TESDA. Tapos yung Seed Capital Fund. Then meron din po yung cash for building livelihood assets. Parang cash for work to, pero ang end point nito ay makaka-build ng assets yung community. Yes. Apa. Apa, ibibigay ko po. Sige po, Your Honor.
It's for rebels, yon ganon. Ano ginagawa niyo doon? Conflict areas.
Okay. Yes, Madam Chair. Yung pamana po ay projects allotted to communities in conflict areas. Okay. So ang amount ng grant ay 300,000 per barangay. So ito po ay open menu rin po ito. So basically we subject, it's a facilitated process, meaning the community is assisted in identifying the project. Okay. But yes, yun po yung, briefly, yun po yung pamana. At ang budget na nakalaan po dyan for 2017 that we're proposing is around 885 million.
So, Madam Chair, ibig sabihin nyo, sa isang community, pwedeng meron siyang kalahi seeds, pwedeng may pamana siya, tapos pwedeng may SLP siya.
Pwede rin po. Actually, parang ano lang, meron din pong, may mga areas na nagtatagpo sila. So, you will note that Pantawid is really for individuals and families. SLP is for the more enterprising poor. And then, kalahi seeds, where pamana is actually lodged, is for the community. So, yun po yung interactions nila.
So, sabihin yung pamana is part of kalahi seeds?
Po, pero it's
as a separate budget.
It's a separate. Pero po, ang OPAC po ang naninili ng mga areas. Kasi ito, yes, for pamana, because these are the identified conflict areas. And in support, well, in relation to the peace process.
Siguro, Madam Chair, can we just request yung listings nung kung sino yung naka-avail nung pamana? And then, pwede din makahingi, kasi di ba meron tayong listahan ng top 10 poorest province? Pwede yung makahingi kung magkano ang ginagastos ng DSWD dun sa top 10 poorest province? Siguro in the past 3 years.
Yes, ang top 10 is tatlong Samar, Western, Eastern, Northern Samar, Sarangani, and what do you call Bukidnon, at saka North Bukidnon, and then Zamboanga del Norte, Lanao ba?
Number 1.
And Maguindanao, and it's Lanao del Sur, no? Maguindanao, I think Basilan yata eh, and Sulu. 10 lang. Wala nang car yata eh, di ba?
Apayaw.
So anyway,
ito daw available.
Actually, top 10 naman based dun sa NEDA.
NEDA.
Yung top 10 ho ba ng NEDA is different from your top 10 sa national targeting?
Anyway,
Actually, wala po kaming top 10. Ang distribution po, kung makikita lang natin yung magnitude, kung saan madami ang mga poor families natin. But we do not label it kasi hindi naman nga kami PSA or NEDA na nag-aano.
Pero pwede nyo i-rank.
We do have...
Based on sa national targeting.
Yes. Based on the magnitude, we even have 20 po, yung top 10.
Top 20 din sa magnitude.
Opo, pero hindi nga lang per PSA or NEDA po. Ito yung, how, ilan ang population nila, ilan ang tinarget namin, ilan ngayon ang result ng poor families din. Magnitude po, hindi yung incidence
lang. Yes, top 20 highest magnitude of poverty.
In fact, yung the 81 provinces po, nirank lang namin po. We will submit to all, Madam Chair. Okay, thank you po.
Well, I think the committee has been enlightened by the presentation today. If we have questions, we will ask you to come again. We are just suspending the meeting. Okay, thank you very much. You please submit all the papers para makapag-aral kami, ha?